Once I turned 15, they started paying me cash. And then I don't think that I worked my entire 15th year for minimum wage. I think I got a raise after that too. But that's how it goes. You know, you keep applying yourself, you keep doing better, you keep getting a better wage.
I think people get ticked off when they see like these, you know, Enron employees making $200 million and they have, you know, they're scraping by on $10 an hour working for these corporations. But the hard thing and what they don't realize is if I have a CEO who makes, you know, $100 million, I'm willing to pay that person $20 million. You know, they don't ever really think past that of, oh, well, the little guy's getting screwed. Look how much this guy's getting. You know what? If you can earn that kind of money, you deserve that kind of money.
Yeah, I'm with people that say that there's nothing really particularly special about what, say, some people do working in Silicon Valley or, you know, making some of these big paychecks. I don't think there's anything particularly impressive between the guy who sells cell phones for a living and the guy who sells, you know, stocks and bonds for a living. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's a big difference. I really don't think there's a big difference. It doesn't change anything about what I'm saying about minimum wage. It's just a bunch of crybaby bullcrap that you're not either A, don't live in the place where this where these jobs are, or B, you haven't done what it is takes to get one of them. And I'm sorry you haven't. I haven't.
All right,
I'm not getting it.
Ian, what was your first job?
Job as in some place where taxes were taken out, or job as in I worked for someone?
Well, tell us both. I mean, what was your first...
My first job would have been working for my mom at her thrift store in Sarasota, Florida as a kid.
See,
I worked there for a number of years.
That's that employment privilege I was talking about.
Ah.
Right? It's child labor. I don't know what you're talking about.
Right, that's exactly it. Child labor is employment privilege.
Did she pay you with thrift, or did you actually get a paycheck?
I got a little bit of money. I don't know.
She wasn't like, yeah, you can have help yourself to these toys. Or
no, I don't remember how much it was, but I did get something out of it. And then the first actual job where taxes were taken out would have been Kmart when I was 16.
Kmart.
Yeah.
There you go.
So we'll come back. We can talk more. We can talk more about the minimum wage if we want. Also, the idea of communicating. How do you get past these walls that people have? Mark, this guy, you say, has some suggestions.
Yeah.
So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and maybe you can share your experiences. Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free. Share your thoughts with us, whether it's on the minimum wage or the larger discussion of how to communicate the ideas of freedom to people who have mental blocks. They are people who would probably agree with us if you could show them this so-called gun in the room. This is a sort of a metaphor for the government, the violence, the aggressive violence of the state, because people don't want to see it, especially if they've spent their entire lives believing that it's not there, or believing that they're somehow, when the state acts, that it's somehow acceptable, whatever it is that they're doing, simply because people have voted for it. I mean, there's all kinds of rationale that people will put behind their belief systems, but it can be difficult, especially the older someone is, to have these conversations. And Mark's got a story that he's going to share with us with some suggestions as to how to approach these discussions with folks. But maybe you would like to explain your experience to us. You're welcome to do so toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Tarrin, you said you've tried out purse.freetalklive.com.
I did. I finally got off my butt and tried it. I have to say, at first, it took me a good 10, 20 minutes to figure out like how to do my first transaction. But
there is a slight learning curve, I would say.
I think I need to make a video for them to help them out.
Okay.
They might appreciate that, because there was a little learning curve. But once you got the hang of it, it was really cool. My first thing I got was some sheet music. And then
percentage off?
I did the instant. The very first time, okay. I was like, I just want to try it.
Instant gratification. So that's actually what most people are doing. We looked
8%.
At the statistics.
Well,
instant 8%?
8% is what it starts at.
Sweet.
And then what I didn't realize is you could slide that bar.
Ah,
and
okay.
There was no instructions. So when you go there, there's like a little bar when you're trying to, it says send Bitcoin. You go there and you can adjust it. And so I'm trying to buy a flugelhorn. And
a flugelhorn?
A flugelhorn.
Flugelhorn?
Is it like a flute
it's
and a
like
bugle?
It's like a combination between, it's like a large trumpet. A trumpet, uh-huh. And a trombone kind of made love and made a flugelhorn.
Okay.
it's kind of like a luxury item. I've always wanted to play one, and it's not something I could really afford. So I went for a big discount on that one, and I went for 41%. So
did anyone bite on that?
It's only been up there 3 days.
Okay.
So
okay.
I don't know. I'll keep you. Come buy me a flugelhorn.
The higher you go above, say, 25%, the less and less likely it'll be to be fulfilled. I tried one just to see what would happen. I put one up for like a week at 50%. And it didn't get, you know, nobody bought a bid on that because there are other Bitcoins. You're essentially competing in a marketplace against other people who are looking to sell their Bitcoins. Because what's happening with Purse is you're putting up your own Bitcoin and then somebody else is buying them, in your case, at 40 whatever percent above the actual cost of Bitcoin. So as you might imagine, it's relatively difficult to find someone willing to do that.
I was trying to think of maybe it's like if they're just really needed to buy a Bitcoin with a credit card, maybe this is the roundabout way to do it, or why they would buy it at 40%, but someone's doing it.
There's different reasons for
it. I got time. I'm just going to wait.
We actually interviewed the CEO of Purse, and he explained that there are people around the world who are, they work with these Mechanical Turk workers for Amazon, and they get paid with Amazon store credit. So what they're doing is they're using their Amazon store credit, turning that into Bitcoin, so they can then use it Bitcoin in more ways.
That's genius.
So it's pretty handy stuff. Go check out purse.freetalklive.com and get your stuff at Amazon at like 20, 25% off easily, or you can try your luck at higher discounts.
Go buy me a flugelhorn, whoever's listening.
Purse.freetalklive.com. So we will go to your calls and thoughts. Scott, listening in Raleigh to Talk Radio 850. Go ahead, Scott.
I think the debate that we're having about what our compensation should be was summed up by a fellow whose book I just read, who uses Uber as an example. And so folks complain that during the peak times, Uber jacks their rates up. Well, I've been doing that for the past 15 or 20 years of my business. I understand that when it starts to get busy, I need to jack it up. And I do, because my value is higher. So he talks about folks that get paid for information and how, you know, arbitrary it is at best. But see here, what we're become as a society is we're giving in a little bit to the convenience. And I think when you talk about this minimum wage, by and large, 80%+ of the people who are lobbying for more money are the restaurateurs that own, you know, the people working in restaurants, fast food restaurants in particular. Now, my McDonald's,
why would they be doing that?
The people in, I'm trying to figure out who's lobbying. Are we talking about fast food restaurant workers, or are we talking about fast food restaurateurs?
No, I misspoke. I mean the workers. They think that their corporations are making, you know, hand over fist and so on and so forth. But I've always thought that the fast food model, let me not put a label of a brand on any one, was during lunch, guess what? Here's my price list. You come in when we're all asleep, here's my price list. I'd have done that 25 years ago, and you would have seen you would have taught people to curtail their behavior, that if you're going to need it now, we're going to charge you now. If you're going to wait 25 minutes or take lunch at 3 o'clock in the instance of restaurants, you're going to get a deal.
I think it's a great idea.
People do that to some extent, right? Like there's a lunch place, or there's a Chinese restaurant here that gives you 50% off sushi during certain lunch hours, right?
Oh, so. And the airline business runs their whole model off that.
Yeah, but he's talking about lunch, and lunch is unique because many employees get like 30 minutes to go eat lunch. Mm-hmm. So you either pack a lunch and eat it at work, or you go and you get fast food because you cannot eat lunch at a restaurant and get back to work. I mean, maybe if it's right next door, you can walk over, eat there, and come back. But in most cases, people are getting in cars, and a car trip takes minimum 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
So you're talking about 10 minutes to eat. So go ahead.
Use the example of a food truck as well. Look at the explosion in food trucks because they're portable. They go to you.
Yep.
So you can get out of your office, per se, go downstairs, get something to eat, and come back upstairs and eat in. I did an experiment for the past 3 weeks. I've been trying not to buy fast food at the place where I work. I've been trying to bring my own food with me. And it's just, I sit down and eat when I can, you know? So I just think that the world's changing right under our very noses. And this argument's going to be a moot point in 10 years.
Scott, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. The world is definitely going to change. You either roll with those changes or you're going to look like a Luddite. You'll look like somebody who just doesn't get it, you know, with the times.
Well, one of these things you'll see on Facebook on a pretty regular basis, I see it on Facebook, is you'll see a picture of a sort of an automated ordering system.
Yeah, and
at McDonald's, and it'll say, you've $15 an hour minimum wage, meet your new store clerk, right? And I mean, that's what it comes down to, is that think about this, Mr. Mm-hmm. and Mrs. Fast Food Consumer. What would you do if you could pay 25% off if you used a little touchscreen. Because this is why the touchscreens don't work, right? Like, I use them almost every time at Home Depot, but they practically have a cashier there doing it.
Well, they have one cashier monitoring four stations.
Four stations. And now,
that's because things go wrong and somebody's got to be there to fix it.
But at least they're cutting their costs greatly by doing that. Sometimes you got to go through the regular cashier. At the grocery store, if you've got alcohol or maybe produce or something, you might want to take the regular cashier. But they have the automated one there, too. And if... you know, if these fast food joints just put a little gizmo there that gave 10% off for people that ordered at it,
it'd
you'd find a lot more people
that.
Using it.
That's how Skynet started.
I bet you'll
be
start
careful.
To see-
Skynet.
All right, we'll come back with more here. I bet you will start to see more of that, though, Mark, where, you know, even in a fast food joint, you got a choice. More coming up here. You can share your thoughts. 855-450-FREE, communicating the ideas of freedom. Coming back.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio, now at your fingertips.
RFlags.com just found out that 49-year-old Anthony Hervey, a black man in Mississippi, he was chased down in his car and killed, apparently for his support of the Confederate flag. This will not stand. RFlags.com now offering 10% of every sale to go to the Hervey family to help them in their time of need. You want to help this family? Go to RFlags.com. We'll donate 10% of every sale. RFlags.com. That's RFlags.com.
If you're David, a few well-chosen words can help level the playing field with Goliath. I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com. Recently, I saw a Yellow Pages ad for an appliance repair company, and the headline read, "Why wait for Sears?" If you're going to the Yellow Pages, the Dead Sea Scrolls of advertising, you're ready to buy right now. So this is an attention-grabbing message. And how about the plumber whose radio ad says, "Call by noon Thursday, and we'll be there Saturday at no extra cost." Smart guy. Most plumbing firms give their crew the weekend off. This one gives them Sunday and Monday off. In the words of a respected advertising executive, "Cut to the chase, make it quick, and tell me exactly what you can do for me, especially if you're looking for work." For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinnertime conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of "what happened today at school," try "what was the best thing that happened today?" The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
Crack cocaine, the way it hurts individuals and communities, I would really like to see dealers get the death penalty.
Why are you so violent?
It's a violent drug. It gets to your brain. It reorganizes. It actually physically changes the structure of your brain.
Yeah, that's true with alcohol.
The community is being put in danger by the fact that these drugs are illegal. I don't use crystal meth, but I'm in danger from those who do use crystal meth, in that if they need another hit and they can't afford it, and their drug dealer's not willing to accept a BJ in order to give them a hit of crystal meth, then they are going to go and steal things, break into cars, break into homes. If you can't see how prohibition creates more problems than it solves, if you can't see how prohibition leads to more violence,
just look at Al Capone and the history of alcohol. Yes. It's simple.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Back now, more Free Talk Live. You can join us here, and we've been talking about the minimum wage. Larger conversation is also happening that we've just scratched the surface of as to how best to communicate the ideas of freedom to people who seem very stuck in their ways, that you know, refuse to see the aggressive violence of the state. They just don't want to see it because it would result in serious cognitive dissonance. If they did, it would result in them having to, if they're a good person, and most people are, it would result in them having to recant and change their viewpoint on things. They would have to say, oh, wow, you know, I've been wrong my whole life. Gosh, that's a pretty tough thing to admit to, right? So that's one of the walls that that people have built up around themselves to protect them from changing their ideas on this. We can talk more about that here in a moment. With you tonight, it's Ian here.
And Tarrin P. Lupo.
And King Mark the First.
To the phones and the fun. Michael's in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live listening to LRN.FM. Hello, Michael.
Hey, have y'all talked about the Sandra Bland incident?
Well, we've talked about it. But,
I don't recall.
Sandra Bland is the activist down in Texas who was arrested and put in jail. And
is this the one who died at the hands of the...
found to have asphyxiated herself, I believe was what they said.
Oh, my. No, I don't think I've been on the show when that's been discussed.
Okay.
Yeah, they... apparently she got pulled over because... you know, she tried to move over when the cop was speeding, and it was a 20-mile-an-hour zone, so she tried to move over. And she got pulled over for not using her blinker. And, you know, the cop, you know, he was going to give her a warning or whatever, and, you know, she didn't want to put her cigarette out. And so that kind of contempt of cop thing started.
Yep.
And he wanted to just, you know, rip her out of the car, and she didn't want to. And, you know, just turned into being arrested for, you know, contempt of cop. And, you know, I watched the video today, and, you know, he never says through the whole video, like, why she's being arrested. And the reason she actually got booked was for assaulting a public official. Which
with her cigarette? I mean, what
is that dangerous cigarette smell?
What are they claiming assaulted? What did she assault him with, allegedly? Do you know?
They claim that she kicked him and scratched him or something like that. But, you know,
I saw the video today. I didn't see the kicking and scratching.
There's a video of the arrest?
Yeah, there was some video that was released.
Okay.
Maybe I should look at more of it, but I didn't see that.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's somebody that recorded it with their cell phone later that it doesn't show it either, but he just kind of mentions it. But anyways, I mean, there's no reason that she should have got arrested.
Sure.
I don't know if it was today or yesterday, but there's like three Texas senators that have come out and said that, you know, there's no reason she should have gotten arrested in the first place.
Well, what's your opinion? If you are getting illegally arrested and, you know, like the cop has no real legitimate reason to arrest you and they start pulling out and basically assaulting you, what is your recourse?
I think it should be the same as if somebody else is trying to kidnap you.
Well, that'd be nice. Unfortunately, you pretty much have to go along with being kidnapped. The more resistance you put up, the more likely you're going to get killed.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I thought it was interesting. The police officer did in the video that I saw, and I'm now looking at a video that's 49 minutes long, so I have no – I watched something that was just a couple of minutes long, that he was asking her to put out her cigarette, and who the hell does he think he is? Like, this is endangering my workplace? No, this is my car. You have pulled over my car at the threat of my death if I don't. Because that's what those lights mean. Those lights mean that if you don't pull over, we're going to call a bunch of other guys with these silly little lights on the top of our cars, and we are going to do what it takes to stop you.
See, that's where you start to lose people, Mark. People don't want to believe that. They don't want to understand that that's the case. But they intimately know it, I think.
Deny it. Yeah. Sure, if you pull over and pull over relatively quickly, you probably won't have a problem. Mm-hmm. If she would have put out her cigarette, she likely wouldn't have had a problem. But you have to, this is supposed to be a country where you have rights. One of those rights is property rights. I said supposed to. And one of those rights is property rights. And that means that in your car, especially if there's nobody else in the car, and I don't see any evidence of anybody else being in the car, you should be able to smoke. And if a police officer doesn't like that, he can get his butt back in his car and drive off.
Michael, anything else you want to share tonight? I mean, what about the jail? Like, what about her experience there? What is known about that? Is there anything that's come out? Because that's where she perished, was not in the hands of this officer, but later.
What I saw from the video, it didn't, I mean, the whole time she's saying, like, I want to see you in court. You know, I'm gonna love taking you to court. I didn't see any, I mean, I don't want to say that there's some conspiracy, but it didn't seem like she was the type of person that is going to kill herself. She wanted to take this to court. She was a activist for, you know, Black Lives Matter, and she wanted to take this to court is what I took from it, and I don't see any reason that she would just kill herself.
What part of Texas was this?
It was Waller County, and I live in Texas, but there's so many counties, I have no idea where Waller County is.
There's more than 100,
there's
I think.
A lot. That's probably like 200, right?
I don't think so.
There's a lot of counties.
There's a lot. I don't know.
Yeah. All right, well, you know, if you hear more about it, Michael, thanks for the call tonight. Let us know, okay? Thank you for the call. I appreciate it.
All right, thanks.
The toll-free number is 855.
254 counties.
Aren't there...
Look, wow. Ian gets to be right.
Isn't there, like, these days, aren't all jails filmed? Aren't you filmed in your cell?
I guess it depends. No, probably not in your cell.
No?
There's privacy issues. In there.
Yeah. Mm. So she committed suicide in her cell.
Yes.
That's what they will allege.
Where it wasn't filmed. So it does look like he was trying to drag her out of her car, and I don't you couldn't see what she did, but it looked like she was putting up some kind of effort to keep being pulled out of the car. That's it, right? Like, this is all about her not putting out her cigarettes.
Yeah,
that's exactly what it's about, because the cop goes up and says, "Ma'am, could you put out your cigarette?" Well, and then now step out of the car. She says, "No, step out of the car."
Mm.
And I don't know what this is like for other people, but I don't want to be pulled out of my car by a police officer.
It's cold out there.
There's no particular or hot or whatever. Yeah. And this is a punishment, right? Like, I couldn't get you to put your cigarette out, so I'll get you to step out of your car because I can. Right. And like, this is somebody who's on a power trip.
Yeah.
And once he says, step out of your car. Then he has to stick with it, because otherwise he loses power.
Good point.
And he's a petty tyrant, right?
He's like,
he's a person with a small amount of power. So he doesn't even have a choice in his own mind to just be like, oh, well, whatever.
Yeah, I remember I got pulled over, and it was just years ago, and the officer wanted me to turn off my radio. And I was like, no, I don't think so. I said, no, I don't want to. And he's like, well, can you turn it down? I was like, no. It's like, if you go give me a ticket, I'm going to listen to some radio while I sit in my car for 10 minutes.
Absolutely.
And what did he do then?
He just went off and wrote me a ticket came back. And actually, you know what? I was actually listening to Free Talk Live, and they were talking about cops. So I turned it up. And no, I got away with it. But, you know, you can tell them no, but...
You didn't get away with it. You got a ticket.
No, actually, the guy didn't show up to court. I challenged it. This was in Georgia,
okay.
In Atlanta. And what happened was I get there, and there's like 100 people in this room, and there's it's a ticket
room
or whatever.
All taking a plea.
And they're there, and they go, okay, everybody who's guilty, stand up, and we'll process you to the back, go to the magistrate. So like 90% of the people get up.
Oh, yeah.
And they go. And then the last 10%, they said, well, if you're here for Officer So-and-so, he didn't show up today, so all your tickets are dismissed.
Sweet.
So they let people incriminate themselves first.
Oh, yeah.
Who got arrested by this officer. There was like 90% of them were like, yeah, give me a ticket. Let's just...
Had they stayed seated, they'd have gotten...
Had they just gone through with it, they would have gotten out of it. So that was
a good story.
That was my learning experience. Always challenge a ticket.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, a friend of mine whose ex-boyfriend used to be a police officer, he said, according to her, that he loved having tickets challenged because it was time and a half.
That's right.
So
they get paid more.
You never know who you're dealing with in any given instance.
Well, it's almost always the case that they're going to get time and a half if they show up, but sometimes they just got to be somewhere else or, you know, whatever. They're just not there. I've had one speeding ticket dropped for the same reason, Tarrin.
Yeah.
But in my case, they waited 3 hours, gave the guy plenty of time to show up, and then they finally called the case, and I motioned to dismiss. So they wouldn't have done it had I not motioned to dismiss the case, I don't think. More coming up here in moments. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Rflags.com just found out that 49-year-old Anthony Hervey, a black man in Mississippi, he was chased down in his car and killed, apparently for his support of the Confederate flag. This will not stand. Rflags.com now offering 10% of every sale to go to the Hervey family to help them in their time of need. You want to help this family? Go to rflags.com. We'll donate 10% of every sale. Rflags.com. That's rflags.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you you can go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait
on account. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Because you scared me.
Property,
what am I being
now.
Detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
LRN.FM is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.FM in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.FM. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You may join us here toll-free, whether you want to talk tales of courtroom drama and success stories in the case of Tarrin getting a ticket down in Georgia. It actually happened recently to Rob Mathias from the Rebel Love Show. He also challenged a ticket in Manchester, went down there, was prepared to record the trial and everything, had his camera and a tripod and cameraman, and they just let it go. It wasn't because the cop didn't show up. They just null-prossed the charges. They just didn't want to deal with it for whatever reason. That was it.
Still a win. I mean,
absolutely. Well, you know, it's never really a win.
Yeah.
Right, because whenever you're dealing with the government bureaucrats, you are going to have your time wasted.
Yeah.
So there, you never do really win. But ultimately, you can minimize the damages and you can at least get a feeling of a victory. Like, you know, if you don't actually end up having to pay them something, then that's better than not.
I think you got to kind of look at the value of the ticket, look at the value of your time. Look how far the place is away, and make up your mind at that point. Like, the tickets here for parking in Keene are $5. I just can't come up with in my mind a justification for, in many cases, like, they, you know, the two times that I fought it, they've made me go to court twice.
Mm-hmm.
Not, you know, there was one sort of an arraignment for a ticket, a $5 ticket, and then for the ticket itself. And you got to have, you know, and you got to go drive down there. There's the gasoline. It costs me more in gasoline to get to this place than it does to, you know, than the ticket itself.
That's why that people just go ahead and pay up.
Yeah, because, that's exactly why.
You know, and it's unfortunate because if people were to challenge the tickets regularly, then they wouldn't be able to schedule them all for trial, and
they
would drop
just
even
raise
more
the price of the ticket so that it made it
justified. They can't get away with it. They can't. There's a huge pushback here in Keene. Mark, you got to remember, you're in New Hampshire, where people are not happy with taxes already. Like, they don't, the people in New Hampshire, even in a lefty town like Keene, they don't want more ticket prices. They don't want it.
Well, if they don't want it, then why don't they go and fight it in court? Why do I have to be the one?
Maybe, you don't have to.
Maybe
you're obviously
some people
not.
Are.
I'm not.
I mean, you know, but for someone like
I'll
me,
do it, and Derek will do it, and Tarrin will do it.
But you see how indignant you get just when I say
I'm not
hey,
indignant
yes,
about it.
But really? That's I'm sorry. That sound in your voice sounded like indignance. Excuse me.
No, I'm not. You do whatever you want, man. If it's not your activism, it's not your activism. But it's a shame that more people don't do it, because if more people did because if more people did challenge these tickets, they would not be able to schedule them all for trial, which would result in more people dropping or these government bureaucrats dropping the tickets. That's not speculation. We've had people report to Robin Hood of Keene. This is a group of activists that fills parking meters for folks to you know, prevent them from getting a ticket in the first place. But obviously they don't get to all of the expired meters. So people have told us that they have, you know, non-activist people we don't know, they've told the Robin Hooders, yeah, I went into the city hall to fight this ticket and they dropped it right there on the spot as soon as I challenged it.
I think it's important, at least for this, is, you know, there's a lot of noobs like me that don't know anything about court.
Yep.
And so it's a very low-risk ticket to learn. Now,
exactly.
If I had the time, I would challenge the five thing. But I understand, Mark, like, when you actually make a real living, you know, when I was making real money, I don't think I would have probably done it. But now I have more time. I probably would for the learning experience alone, because I just don't know how court works, really.
Yeah,
I
think it's worth $5. It's a great educational experience.
I think it's totally worth it doing it to sort of figure out how the system works.
That's one reason. Another good reason is to clog the system up, and we've seen that actually works. And, you know, more people are going to move here who are willing to do this kind of stuff, and then it's going to make life real difficult on them. I think it'd be fun to have, like, a whole row of 20 people go park downtown, get 20 tickets, and then put them all in as a challenge.
And, well, you know what does happen, though, are strangers who are watching will go, oh, well, yeah, I'm not guilty either. And they'll try to get out of their tickets when they see yours dismissed. So it can happen where, you know, someone sees it that wouldn't have ever thought to do it.
Yep, that's absolutely true. So it is kind of an outreach in that way as well. So whether you want to tell us a court story or discuss the lady in Texas who died suspiciously in jail, did the guards take her to a place that was out of camera view, in this case her cell, and then, you know, strangle her to death? Or did this woman actually strangle herself? Or was it another inmate who did it? I don't know what the real story is, and we may never actually find out. But if you know more and you want to share, you're welcome to join us here at 855-450-FREE. We were also discussing the minimum wage and this story, Mark, that you just scratched the surface of at the beginning of the hour. About communicating with people. Do you want to pick that back up?
Yeah, absolutely. I thought it was a great story. I don't think we really even got anywhere with it.
We got through a sentence or two.
We went somewhere else.
Freemansperspective.com. Last week, I posted an article entitled, "Man is Not Always Blind," and quite understandably, I received comments from readers who disagreed. After all, when you're surrounded by people who wish not to see, you hate who hate you for trying to make them see, it's natural to take that opinion. Mm-hmm. And since the word is often fitting, I'll go ahead with brainwashed to describe those who wish not to see. But rather than debating, is it getting any better, I'd like to move on to actually making things better. And that means talking to people. So, since there's something of an art to speaking to the brainwashed, I will direct the rest of this article to this art. To begin, let's start by removing the divide. You and I have made the same mistakes these people are making. We may be a few steps ahead of them in leaving the swamp, but we started in the same swamp with them.
Most people, yeah, that's true.
And this is, I
think... Unless their parents were... libertarians or voluntarists. Or
yeah, and one thing's important here is this is about convincing people on all levels. This isn't just about libertarianism. This is about convincing people in all kinds of different ways.
Okay.
So, you know, if you're trying to convince people, just remember that you weren't always convinced. I'm very frustrated with people that are, you know, still learning the things that I know. It's like, God, how many times do I have to tell you? And the answer
is not going to help if you say
as
that.
Many as it takes.
Yeah.
And you know that
hopefully you're saying that in your head rather than out loud.
Well, I really what I'm saying in my head is that I'm just sick and tired of dealing with human beings. Mm. Like I'm just
that's why you have pigs.
Frustrated. Well, they're you know what? I can at least I know how to deal with pigs. When it comes to human beings, it's just so frustrating to deal with people. They can be so pig-headed.
Mm. I get it because I think there's a burnout where think of it like a hotel on fire that you're going down and you're knocking all the doors and telling everybody it's on fire. Let's get out. Let's get out. Let's get out. And then someone wants to stand at the door and argue with you for 30 minutes that there's no fire. You know, I just go, no, let's go to the next door. And I try to save as many as I can. So at this point in my activism, I just go for the low hanging fruit. I don't go for the difficult ones to, you know, I'm going to get my father to understand everything.
I'm with you on that, you Tarrin. Know, it is absolutely a numbers game to me, and you only have so much time. So you can only spend your time on so many people. We'll be doing an outreach booth at the county fair coming up next week. It's sort of my carny week, which I really enjoy the hell out of.
I want to hear you practice your carnival barking.
Yeah, it's not quite like that.
I want to call you a barker. That's a professional
Daryl's
term.
Daryl's actually really good at doing the carny barking stuff. But, but you know, it's the same thing there. If somebody comes along, and this is an old rule for outreach booths, eventually somebody's going to come along who's like some political junkie, and they just want to stand at the booth and just yap, and talk about whatever their issues are with libertarianism. And you got to get those people out of there, man, because for everybody that is just yakking their head off at the booth, there's 50 people walking by that you're not able to actually reach out to. So it's the same kind of thing. I'm totally with you. But there are those people who, you know, they're still stuck on the I got to convince dad or their best friend or worse, their wife or their husband.
They love them. That's why they want to convince
hard.
Them.
And I get it, and I'm not against. I mean, there was a time when I had that kind of energy in my 20s that I would sit there and, you know, try to talk someone and talk someone and talk someone I loved. But I think it's just all of us have been doing this a long time, man. I think you just go for the burnout after a while that I'm not willing to go after these people anymore like I used to be. I go for the ones that are just right close to my level. Just bring them a little further.
I believe that, you know, what my system is to live and let live as far as it goes. Look, everybody wants to say when you believe in the ideas of liberty, let's agree to disagree, right? Like they want to agree to disagree with you. And I, you know, when I'm having a conversation with somebody I don't love and don't want to have a particular relationship with them, I will just go ahead and, you know, let them know, you know, that you're agreeing to disagree about initiation of violence against peaceful people, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you're an a-hole, and you want me to agree that it's okay that you're an a-hole. And, like, I don't mind using terminology with people like that because I don't particularly care if I convince them. When I'm talking about people that I care about, I'm really, they know what my position is. I'll explain my position, and that's fine. I really don't push it on them. I let them slowly internalize it because what people want is they want to be loved and accepted. They want to be heard. They want to be comfortable. And if you allow them to have those things, they'll come along because what people are very bad at is being convinced. You know, if I'm able to convince you of something, that makes me smarter in that area. And people don't want you to be smarter, especially if you're talking about, you know, moms and dads and uncles and aunts and that sort of those brothers and sisters.
Let's come back with more of this discussion here in moments. You are welcome to add your story into the mix. Maybe you can explain how you were brought on board or how you successfully managed to bring somebody on board with the ideas of freedom at 855-450-FREE. More coming up in hour two.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
I'm a carbon fiber 29er full suspension mountain bike. My owner and I are attached to the hip, literally. Or we were, until the apartment got robbed while he was at his vinyasa yoga class, and the burglar used me to make his getaway. My owner's gonna be uber bummed when he realizes I'm gone. I guess he'll have to find another way to get his daily dose of adrenaline. Maybe he can take up urban beekeeping.
Your stuff can't protect itself. That's why the Geico Insurance Agency helps make it easy to switch and save on renter's insurance. Renter's insurance will cover personal property loss or damage, as well as provide liability protection. Visit geico.com today.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, July 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.75 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,091 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $279. Antiwar.com reports Pentagon officials are claiming that Mohsen al-Fadli, an al-Qaeda figure who they accuse of being the leader of the Khorasan faction, was killed in a U.S. airstrike earlier this month in the Aleppo province of northern Syria. U.S. officials have claimed Fadli was the target of several previous airstrikes against al-Qaeda and had speculated in the past that he was killed. Al-Qaeda's Syria faction, Jabhat al-Nusra, has not indicated whether or not the Kuwaiti-born Fadli was targeted or killed. When U.S. airstrikes target al-Qaeda forces in Syria, they usually attribute them as Khorasan figures, though it is widely acknowledged that the term Khorasan is itself a U.S. manufacturer and primarily used to try to convince Syrian rebels that Nusra, a top rebel force, is not being targeted. The U.S. seems somewhat less concerned with targeting Nusra in the recent months, however, since there are fewer and fewer U.S. allies among the rebels to begin with, except for a tiny U.S.-created faction that the U.S. has dubbed the New Syrian Force.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports an appeals court on Tuesday overturned four of Rod Blagojevich's corruption convictions, a ruling that may or may not result in less prison time for the former Illinois governor. Blagojevich was convicted in 2011 on 18 counts of corruption charges, including trying to sell the U.S. Senate seat of President Barack Obama. He was sentenced to 14 years in prison at a facility in Colorado. Judges with the U.S. Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals overturned four of those convictions, saying that his attempt to appoint Valerie Jarrett Garrett in Obama's former Senate seat in exchange for a position on Obama's cabinet was a common exercise in log rolling. The ruling said this did not violate the law. In his appeal, Blagojevich's lawyers argued a number of errors were made by Judge James Zagel, including improperly instructing the jury about the law concerning fraud, extortion, and bribery. The overturned convictions could mean a reduction in sentencing for Blagojevich, though that may be unlikely. The Seventh Circuit Court's opinion said removing the four convictions does not affect the sentencing range. The judges also said Zagel's sentence in the first place was perhaps too lenient. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Facebook cannot challenge search warrants New York prosecutors used to get information from its site on hundreds of users suspected of Social Security fraud, according to a state appeals court on Tuesday, in a decision likely making it harder for New Yorkers to keep their digital lives private. The warrants, which applied to 381 users' photos, private messages, and other account information, could only be challenged by individual defendants after prosecutors gathered evidence, according to the Manhattan-based court. Facebook was backed in the case by a group of large internet companies, including Google and Microsoft, which argued the case could set a troubling precedent, giving prosecutors access to all kinds of digital information. Internet companies are pushing back broadly against U.S. intelligence and law enforcement agencies' demands for customer data in the wake of revelations by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden of wide-ranging online surveillance. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office served the warrants on Facebook in 2013, seeking information on dozens of people later indicted for Social Security fraud, including police officers and firefighters who allegedly feigned illness in the wake of the September 11, 2001 attacks. The world's biggest online social network turned the records over to prosecutors last year after a state judge threw out its claim that the warrants violated users' Fourth Amendment rights, but it also went ahead with the appeal. A Facebook spokesman said the company disagreed with the decision and was considering an appeal. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
With each successive bite failing to relieve his anxieties, increasingly worried man Dylan Hawks told reporters today that he has yet to come across any trace of guacamole in his burrito, despite having specifically requested it when ordering.
No, there definitely wasn't any guac there. Cheese, beans, chorizo. Oh man, I hope they didn't forget.
Hawks has continued to maintain hope that there may still be an undiscovered sliver of avocado somewhere in his tortilla. However, with his fears for the meal mounting, Hawks has reportedly considered asking the cashier for a refund at various points while eating the burrito.
The thing is, if you had a burrito and it was missing cheese, you might not notice it because there's sour cream, but guacamole is completely different. I just don't know how I wouldn't have tasted it by now. Christ, I'm almost done with this thing.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll free to join us here and discuss the issue of communicating the ideas of freedom effectively with people who put up all kinds of barriers to coming to the same conclusions that many of us have done. Mark has an article from a blog or a story that will share some tips, some suggestions on how to do that more effectively. You can also share your experiences with us here or bring up anything that's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. And also Skype username here tonight is lrn.fm. Joining you, it's Ian.
Tarrin B. Lupo.
And King Mark the First.
Right into your calls and thoughts. We'll start with Joe listening in Alabama. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Joe.
Hello. I've got two comments I would. The first one, you talk about changing people's minds. I don't really know if you can change their mind, but you can direct them in a certain way where they can change their thinking. The philosophy of liberty is about an 8-minute video I picked up off of Daryl W. Perry's website.
Yep.
And I think it's also on Free King Facebook. Well, yep. That is a great video that if anybody watches it, they're going to scratch their head and say, wow, why haven't I not thought of this sooner?
Yeah, the philosophy of liberty we have posted up on our Facebook page. I can't tell you how many times.
It's a golden video.
It really is awesome.
It's a great intro. It's simple. The animation's real simple. It's like stick figure style animation, and it's been around for a long time.
But I can tell you, some people get angry at watching it.
Really?
Like it's just like I don't want to watch that video again. You know, like for whatever reason, it's not convincing to them. Obviously, there's no such thing as a panacea. Yeah. I still think it's one of the best things going, but.
Wow.
I've seen people, and it's just kind of hilarious.
Interesting.
You know what's actually pretty interesting is that was the first Liberty video, I think, to really be translated, especially to Arabic. And it got really big overseas in Arab countries because, you know, they don't get to see much stuff like that.
Sure, and it's actually been translated into quite a few languages from what I understand.
Yeah, so, I mean, kudos.
Joe, good suggestion. Anything else you want to share tonight? Go ahead.
Yes, now... I just have to catch certain things on how people do off the video on different things, but I think in King, they go to schools and pass out literature that helps people see. You know, if you start when people are young, their minds can change a little bit easier.
That's true, but on the other hand, I've done this activism, but on the other hand, some of the parents are going to get upset, right? And then they're going to build up their wall a little thicker as a result of that.
How dare you open that child's mind?
Go ahead, Joe.
So that did not work well?
Oh, well, it just depends on who you ask.
Who knows how well it worked as far as opening the minds of kids? We don't know.
I can tell you that there was years ago. I mean, we've been doing the school outreach for years. We took a couple years off when Derek J. left because he was pretty much my main partner going out there doing that stuff, and now he's back, so we re-kicked it off again this year. But I remember years ago there was one young lady who approached me when she was in high school, and she said that she had actually saved the flyer that we'd handed her back when she was in like eighth grade. She was, because we do the middle school, high school, and college outreach. And so she had actually said that she'd saved that flyer and she like put it up on her bedroom wall.
Wow.
And you know, that's when you hear stories like that, it kind of, you know, means something to you.
I actually think that the younger generation, when I talk to them, they're a lot more liberty minded than I ever was or anyone I knew. The internet changed everything. Like, this information was really hard to get when I was a kid. I started with the Henry Brown and Ron Paul campaigns back in, Harry Brown in 96. And then I even was volunteering when I was 16 at the Ron Paul 88. And that was like a big deal to learn what that was. Where now, man, kids get that stuff all over their Facebook pages and you know, cop brutality and activism, and it's just, I have a lot of hope. I think the next generation sees a lot more than we ever did.
I think it's worth it personally, because ultimately this is a numbers game, and in this case the numbers are the time numbers, that the parents are not going to be around as long as the children are. So if I have to pick one age group over another to talk to, I'm going to pick the younger people. If I'm standing at the outreach booth at the Cheshire Fair and I got an older couple walking by and a young couple walking by, I'm going to pick the younger couple to talk to. My time is limited, and so I'm going to go with the people.
It's not just a 50. It's not like it's 50-50 here either. There's just plenty of science out there that shows that older people are harder to convince of things than younger people are. The neuropathways are set, and they're not going to change their mind. If they vote Democrat, they're going to vote Democrat. If they vote Republican, they're going to vote Republican. And they're sure not going to listen to some youngster telling them otherwise.
And older people are getting more out of the system than younger people are who are donating in. So, you know, once you're on the take, the government take, it's pretty hard to convince someone to leave that ride.
Right, you're talking about Medicare here. I mean, currently, Social Security, but Social Security is about an even wash. You're going to get about 100% back of what, on average, of what you put into Social Security. Let's assume you're not male or poor or black, in which case your chances are going to go down with each one of those. But you're going to get about 100%. But currently, the people who are getting Medicare, they've put in about 30 cents for every dollar they're getting out. That's just full-on theft. Where the hell do you think that other 70 cents is coming from?
Joe, thank you for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype, and that's where Nick is on the line. Hello, Nick. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Tarrin, and Mark.
Hey. So, speaking of young libertarians, my friend of mine and I created a little Facebook group that I thought I would share on here called, it's just entitled High School Libertarians. It's a group.
They didn't already have that on Facebook?
There's a page, like political organization or whatever, but this is a group.
Cool.
And the idea is basically just like we're going to have like little video, maybe not necessarily video, but like Skype chats or whatever, maybe use a more efficient service or whatever if we have more people or something. But basically, we're just going to be a discussion group. We're just going to talk about whatever we want to talk about, you know. And so
now, are these your local friends? You actually have more than one friend who's a libertarian?
Oh, I actually do. I actually do have more than one friend who's libertarian.
Okay, that's good.
And actually, who were libertarians before I was, even.
Cool. Where are you, by the way? Where are you calling from?
Cincinnati, Ohio.
Okay.
So you're, but, just to recap, you're trying to get people to do like a Google Hangout and all chat with each other about libertarian ideas that are high school age?
Yeah, basically.
Cool. All right.
And you're looking for people around the globe who are in high school?
Thanks. The person who started it with me is from Kansas, so, mm-hmm. you know.
You said in the United States or worldwide?
Anywhere. It doesn't matter.
It's a page, Facebook page. Anybody can join it.
Yeah. You said it was a group,
though,
right?
As long as you don't advertise sunglasses.
Didn't you say it was a group, not a page?
It is a group, yes.
Okay, I'm not able to find it.
You'll have to...
Is it a secret group?
It shouldn't be. Are you not able...
Well, you know how Facebook is. It's weird. Sometimes it just doesn't show. If it's brand new, maybe it's just not going to show up in the results when you search for it. It might be something that I don't think I'm mistyping it. I'm typing.
I've got High School Libertarians Political Organization.
That's a page. It's not a group.
What's that?
Anyway,
it's a difference.
That's a page, not a group. The difference, Mark, between a page and a group on Facebook is a page is something like the Free Talk Live page,
yep.
where administrator types post to the page. You can make it so people who are users of the page can
groups
post to it.
Groups are more chatty.
Groups are where you can actually interact more with other people. There are certain things you can do on a group that you can't do in a page. Like on a group, you can ask a poll question of the group members. Groups can also be secret. They can be closed and they can be open, whereas a page, they're always public. There's no secret pages. Pages are like sort of the place where you would want to send people who are interested in your brand, whereas a group is more of it's sort of Facebook's version of a forum. It's a crappy version of a forum, but that's what Facebook has. And groups are a little more interactive, a little more personal. You can see more about the members in a group versus the people who like a page. So maybe it's just because it's brand new, Nick, and I wish you the best of luck with your project.
Nick, if I can give you this advice too, find some libertarians that you dig and invite them to come to the hangout to talk to some high school kids, man. That'd be awesome.
That's
activism.
A cool idea.
Yes. Okay, so, well, the point of coming on here, of course, is to let any other high schoolers who may be listening know to look it up. And of course,
hopefully they can find it. Here's what you should do. What you should do is send your link to the High School Libertarians group to the Free Talk Live page, not on Facebook, but the Free Talk Live website. So if you go to freetalklive.com, submit the link directly to your High School Libertarians group on Facebook. That way people can just go to our site and they'll find the link. It'll be easy for them. Nick, thanks for the call tonight. If you want to go to freetalklive.com, you should do that. More coming up.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I'm Mark Stevens of the No Stay Project, and are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're only helping the government. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, spread it. So get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Back now with more Free Talk Live. Time for you to join us here if you want at 855-450-FREE and via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Whether you are a high school libertarian or you're upset that some libertarians reached out to your high school student, you can talk about anything you want to discuss here. We've been kind of all over the map tonight with an overarching conversation about communicating the ideas of liberty and effectively doing so. The article, Mark, that you're sharing with us, which has some suggestions, is about dealing with brainwashed people, apparently, and not just from the perspective of the freedom movement and trying to bring people on board with these ideas. But that does seem to be where this guy's from. Like, he is a liberty guy, right, who's writing this?
Yes.
It's from the Freeman blog?
Freeman's Perspective.
Freeman's Perspective. So let's continue that here in a moment. I just also want to let you know about ProXPN first, because if you're online at all, you do need to protect yourself, and you can't count on your internet service provider to do it for you. You have to take the steps to do this. You go to proxpn.com/FTL. Download their app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and Linux. Get started with it, and they will encrypt your internet connection, which means your own internet service provider won't be able to spy on you, know what you're doing online, maybe logging all the websites you visit and the search terms that you enter for some cases as many as several years, and then doing who knows what with that information.
They can't collect that data if you're encrypted, and ProXPN will do that for you. They're also, with their premium account, they'll give you unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. You get all of that and a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee by using code FTL50. That gets you 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy their annual account. Again, the code is FTL50, works the price down to around $5 per month, and it's good for the lifetime of your accounts. It's really an awesome deal, but you can start right now for free. There's no reason not to try this out. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. You can get started there. And don't forget code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we continue here, Mark, you had begun to share some of the suggestions here by the Freedom, what was it, Freedom Man?
The Freeman's Perspective.
Freeman's Perspective. Okay. Do we know who the name of the author is, or is he just the Freeman?
That's kind of how it goes when you have a blog, is you can obscure that. But actually, his name is Paul Rosenberg.
Paul Rosenberg. Okay.
Oh,
great.
All right.
So
that
going
sounds
on.
Familiar.
Yeah, it does. But I mean, you know, I don't know.
He's on Freedom's Phoenix a good bit.
Is that so? Okay, great.
So he says, let's start by removing the divide. You and I have made the same mistakes these people are making. We may be a few steps ahead of them in leaving the swamp, but we all started in the same swamp together.
Some people will say this is condescension, right? Think you libertarians think you're so enlightened. What do you say to that?
Well, I think that everybody, this is about convincing people, right? So you need to, when talking to people about convincing somebody of something, you're going to necessarily come from the standpoint that I know something, that, you know, the person you're talking to knows something, or at least the very least believes they know something that they're trying to convince somebody else of. I don't care if you're trying to, if it's veganism, your religion, the ideas of liberty, or, you know, what it is. People are trying to convince people of things all day long.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the worst things you can do, he's pointing out here, one of the worst things you can do is believe that your customer is wrong or stupid. If you are coming from the standpoint that your customer is wrong or stupid, you need a vacation.
Yeah.
Really, really badly. You need a break, because you're not going to convince anybody of anything.
Well, you need a vacation, Mark, because you're constantly talking about how you think people are stupid.
Yeah, well, I believe that my whole life.
And that is definitely condescending, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it.
No.
But I agree with you that, at least I agree with what you're saying, Mark, and that is that you do have to empathize with people, put yourself in their shoes, and see yourself as that person.
But I would like to point out, though, Ian, when I say that people are stupid, I usually use it in a fashion that the listener can agree with, because the vast majority of people believe that people are stupid.
Mm.
I mean, I love the George Carlin joke that says, that is talking about the average. Think about how smart the average person is. Now realize that the 50% of people are dumber than that. And I frankly don't think that since the average person isn't very smart, I'm talking about the 80-20 rule here. In any given arena, you should not listen to 80% of people. And I'm willing to say that when it comes to, you know, auto repair, brain surgery, carpentry, maybe on carpentry, like I might be able to wade into the shallow end of the pool on carpentry. But the vast majority of things, I'm a dum-dum. So I'm not going to listen to most people on most issues. However, when it comes to the ideas of liberty, I've spent a lot of time thinking about the morality, the causality of these ideas. And it's rare that somebody brings something to the table that I have not heard before.
I like the title to Lionel's book, the talk show host. Everyone's crazy except you and me. And I'm not so sure about you.
Yeah, there's a little. That's just a bite off the thee and me thing, and I'm not so sure about thee.
All right, go on.
Yeah. Anyway, in all of human history, there may be no greater conditioning system than our modern government schools, including all the private schools that follow the same pattern. And I believe this to be the case. I went to the best private school in town, and all it was a better public school. I mean, essentially, you took, well, here's a surprise. If you take a bunch of white upper middle class kids and you put them in one school, they're going to do better than the rest of the kids. What a surprise. They do nothing different. Essentially, they just bought textbooks. They just bumped up the grade level of the textbooks. That's about it. Anyway, from infancy to adulthood, it affects most human minds in the West. And I dare guess that 98% of my readers bear these scars. And he's saying that 98% have been to public school, but I still think that you're not getting out of the conditioning system anyway. If you're around 98% of the population has been educated by a particular system with a particular goal in mind, and that is, you know, that the government is a competent educator of people. If it's competent in educating people, which they will make the argument that it is, then it must be competent at other things that it does. And there's no evidence for any of these statements. Mm-hmm. So if you're around 98% of the people, then the synergy of those 98% is going to, infect the other 2%.
Yeah, but nobody likes to think that they're the ones that are the problem or that they're the ones that really didn't get a good education. If you talk to someone that went to a government school, you'll always hear them say, yeah, government schools are terrible, but mine was okay. I learned something in mine. They'll never really
own up to... Yeah, I turned out okay. I've got a job. I've got a business.
I go home and watch American Idol. I'm fine.
They don't know what they could have been. They don't know if they could have been better.
I think it really disturbs my friends when I always complain. I was like, you know, I went to government school. I don't know these things. And they'll be like, you know, they'll get really mad at me, especially if, you know, they're teachers. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, yeah, the government school teachers, I mean, they're thoroughly invested, right? I mean, that's the best teaching job you can get. You don't want to go to private. The only people at the private schools are the ones that at the very high-end private schools that might get paid a bit more, or the ones that are at the religious schools that are, you know, there because they, you know, they're on board with the religion.
Mark, you're trying to ask 98% of the people to come to terms with maybe they didn't get such a great education, and maybe they're not as smart as they thought they were, well-educated. Well, you know, that's a hard reality for
some
people.
I'd ask anyone to, would you send, given that it costs no money, would you send your kid to the best private school in your area or the best public school? Because I believe that public schools are essentially the worst schools in a given geographic area, so bad that they have to be funded by force.
All right. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. More Free Talk Live is coming up.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit LibertyOnTheRocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're welcome to join us here, discuss persuasion, how to communicate the ideas of freedom more effectively with people. We're going to get into more from the Freeman's perspective. Paul Rosenberg wrote this piece that you're sharing with us here, Mark, throughout the show. We're kind of off and on it as we go off on side tangents and related discussions. And we're going to continue that here. Also want to let you know that Keenvention is coming up. It's happening. It's going to be October 30th through November 1st. It's the third annual, but it's going to be Tarrin Lupo's first ever Keenvention. Tarrin, you've never been before.
I have never been. I'm very excited. I'm already planning my Halloween costume.
Yeah, there's going to be the Halloween costume dance party that's going to happen as well. That's included in the ticket price for Keenvention, which is all of $60 for an entire weekend. If you've ever been to a convention-style event before, you know you're going to be paying at least $100, if not $200, for a full weekend at pretty much, especially industry conventions. You're looking at $400-$500.
Thousands.
If not thousands, yeah.
I'm hoping to wear my costume the entire weekend, even on stage.
That would be pretty epic.
just if it'll bring more people.
I think it will certainly be entertaining for the video because we actually record every single thing that happens on stage. So all the panel discussions, the keynote speeches, they all get recorded, which means you can go to keenvention.info right now or whenever you want, and you can watch all of the curriculum from 2013 and 2014. It's all up there for you to see what it's like. But the thing you won't experience by watching the videos is you won't experience what it's actually like to be there in the audience and to meet the people and to talk to the activists and to go to the social events. Like last year we had a great bonfire and Halloween. So there's only so much the video can do to communicate right. It, but it's a great event. It's intimate. You really get to know people. And it's about activism. We don't bring in fancy big name speakers from all around the country. You, Tarrin, would not have been able to speak at Keenvention previously if you didn't live in New Hampshire. You've got to be an activist in New Hampshire to qualify to be on stage, basically.
I remember I approached you about it like a year ago, and you were like, nope, you don't live here. Let me know when you live here. So I got shot down once.
Yeah.
This time it was good.
That's one of the things that makes Keenvention special is that we only focus on the New Hampshire activism scene, and we only talk about the different kinds of activism that goes on here because it's such a wide-ranging movement. Everything from inside the system, political action. We'll have the legislative panel this year, and Daryl Perry, our Friday night host, he's going to be heading up a political action panel, which would be different from the legislative panel.
I think I watched one last year on YouTube about the one I thought was most useful was you had a bunch of media people.
That's right. It was probably Mark's panel.
Was that Mark's?
Yeah, he hosted the media panel. Really informative.
I learned a lot.
Real grassroots kind of how to start your own podcast or video show kind of info. We'll have another media panel this year. Actually, Shire Dude has committed to heading up this year's media panel.
Notice I do a great job. He doesn't ask me back. This is what it's like working with this guy.
Really?
Yeah,
that's what I'm expecting.
It's important to put the focus on different activists, Mark, and not have it be the same people every single year. That doesn't
the same
mean that,
successful people.
That doesn't mean that Shire Dude won't invite you to be on his panel, Mark. I don't know who he's going to invite.
I don't think that I bring that much to a panel. What I put together on that media panel was the intent. It was a great panel because it was intended to inform people about how to put together their own media.
And it did.
What the hell do I know about that? Find some dork 10 years younger than you to do a show for you? I mean, that's all I can really say about how to put together media.
It's working.
Funny and interesting and those kind of things, but there wouldn't be a micro. But I'd be those kind of things without a microphone in front of me. So, I couldn't put the microphone in front of myself.
Go to keenvention.info. You can go get tickets there through Eventbrite with your credit card, or you can actually pay with Bitcoin and get your tickets that way as well. It's October 30th through November 1st. It's a lot of fun. And we'll look forward to seeing you there. There's only 100 tickets available in advance, and I can tell you about 95% of them are currently still available. So
it'll fill up. I got faith.
It does.
This year.
It always happens. It always happens like in the last 2 months. That's when everybody. You know, it doesn't even matter. You can deep discount the early bird tickets as deep as you want, and it won't spur anybody to buy early.
I think people get so hyped up for Pork Fest, and everything's Pork Fest. That you just need some decompression time. That you need a month or two where you're not talking about events. But soon you'll start be itching to see everybody again.
So come on up, join the fun, keenvention.info. We'll look forward to seeing you there. And also, we'll tell you more about ExpressCoin coming up here later tonight. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We were talking about your story, Mark. You wanted to continue sharing some suggestions on communicating the ideas of freedom. Go ahead.
Yeah. So Paul Rosenberg is here. He's saying, so you must start out by understanding that these brainwashed people have spent a huge portion of their lives inside a massive mind warp. He's talking about the government school system here. Mm. Don't be too quick to toss them aside. Learn patience. Breaking out of their old mold is scary, and it takes time. And I think that this is sort of really true. The few people that I've managed to sort of in my personal life to convince to these ideas, I did not do it quickly.
Of course not. Your wife being one of them, right?
Yeah. My wife is sort of chief among them. I think that she's much better at convincing people of things than I am. Mm-hmm. So I would ask her questions. I happen to have a nationally syndicated radio program, so I have this advantage, but, you know, maybe you can phrase it like, you know, I have a friend at work I'm trying to convince of something. How would you go about trying to explain that everything the government does, it does by force? And at that point, you know, hopefully, if you've been dating them for some time, they understand this idea to some extent. And then if they can come up with ways to convince someone else, then they're teaching themselves. And
that's a good strategy.
Yeah, it's an incredibly good strategy. And so that's what one. And you ask people this for all kinds of different things. I've asked that for people with regarding Robin Hooding here in Keene, New Hampshire. Some activists go around and put quarters in meters. They follow around the meter maid, and in order to prevent her from writing tickets, they put quarters or nickels or dimes in meters in order.
Technically,
to
you walk in front of the meter maid. Whatever.
So they attempt to figure out what direction the meter maid is going at any given time. And it's become controversial. Like, feeding meters has become controversial in Keene because it's been done so effectively here.
That's right.
And I ask people when I've had this conversation is, well, if you thought that the metering system in Keene was bloated and archaic and needed to be changed— and you knew that the city council wasn't going to listen to anything you said, no matter how you said it, what would you do? How would you go about it? How would you go about creating that change? And at that point, then their mind is working on a new problem. Not the old problem is, how do I get rid of these activists? I hate activists. Activists are stupid. Because everybody thinks that. There's nobody in the world that just thinks,
not
you know what I don't do? Hang out with a bunch of activists. Maybe activists that believe like you do, but not activists. Because people almost across the board just hate activists. And so once you get them working on the problem, then they start to see things newly. Going on. The roots, Paul says, the roots are deep and old. They are backed up with violence and fear. It comes down to this. The very existence of the state requires you to be brainwashed. Every state, communist, fascist, theocratic, whatever, results in the same concept of legitimacy. It is right that one group of men take everyone else's money by force and tell them what to do. It is right that they punish or kill anyone who doesn't obey them. It is right that they send your children to fight and die children to die fighting their competitors. This is what people think in every country throughout time, because if they didn't think this way, they would be killed. People tend to do what is expedient. They tend to consider what is expedient, what is moral. And it isn't always the same thing, especially when what is moral is not expedient.
I think the most success I ever had was to find common ground, and you got to go to morality, because people make decisions emotionally. They don't make them logically.
Yep.
So an example would say something like, you and I agree on 95% of this. I get what you're saying. I wish we both want the same thing, but I just wish there was a way that didn't involve violence to do this. Can you think of a good way? And that disarms them tremendously when you agree with what they're saying and then say, but I'd like to see it without the violence. Because people want to think they're a good person.
And generally they are, right?
They are. They just never thought about it, honestly, that they're using violence.
All right, we'll come back with more here. And, of course, you can share your experiences. Maybe you can share how you got brought on board. What was the tactic that worked with you? Or the reverse, what was it that worked on other folks? 855-450-FREE.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while. But once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX, or my website, danpilla.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallo Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. Keenevention.info.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and of course you can join us here and talk about persuasion. How do you more effectively communicate the ideas of freedom to people? Get them to come to conclusions on their own by asking questions rather than making declaratory statements about how right you are. So we're going to continue. Mark, you've got the story you're sharing with us. It's Ian, Tarrin, and Mark in the studio here tonight. Also, want to invite you over to freetalklive.com, where you get lots of features, and they're all totally free. We've got archives that go back for years. We now actually have video archives of the show that has gone back for several months now that we've been doing it regularly. That's all available on our YouTube. Our archives are available right through our website. So go to freetalklive.com and explore around. There's a lot of content there, and it's all free. So go to freetalklive.com. Mark, let's continue here with the Freeman's Perspective blog.
So Paul Rosenberg is explaining sort of how to really not necessarily how to convince people yet. He's talking now how to just sort of take a deep breath and understand that you were once in these people's position too. Mm-hmm. So he says, that he's explaining how the state, whether it is a communist, fascist, theocratic, or whatever, rests on a concept of legitimacy. It's right that one group of men take everyone else's money by force and then tell them what to do. It's right that they punish or kill anyone who doesn't obey them. It's right that they send your children to die fighting their competitors. If I wanted to apply this to Marvin and Bob, who live down the street, you'd tell me I was crazy. You'd be right. Why then is it, and what I think he means by that, because he doesn't really explain it very well, is that, the state is really just people. So if some guy down the street came to your house and said, hey, look, I've really got a really great idea. I'm going to educate all the kids in the particular area, and I want you to give me some money to do it. And you're like, I think this is a good idea, but I'd like to wait and see how well you do before I start putting my money in. And he says, oh, no, I'm going to shoot and kill you if you don't do it right now. Mm. Like, that guy's a maniac. But don't think that the government, like in the form of the IRS, won't use bullets to put you in a cage ultimately if you resist. Like, that's what the government does. Now, the local government, they aren't quite as bad. They'll take your house from you, and if you then refuse to exit the house, that's when the guys with guns come and who will use bullets if you resist. Mm-hmm. So ultimately, that's what the state is. The state is an organization that will kill you if you don't like its ideas.
Let's talk to Dax. He's in Dallas, Texas. Dax, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Tarrin, and Mark.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Hey, go ahead, Dax. Good.
I wanted to talk about a guy that was on Tom Wood's show. And, he's right when he says, if you're talking to somebody, I don't care what their opinion is. Just make them think that you respect them when you engage them, and then they will respect you. And that just makes so much sense. It's right.
Yep.
So
it comes down to respect is where you got to start. And if somebody doesn't feel, if they don't feel that you care, they don't. If they don't think that you care, then they don't care what you think, I think is what the old saying is, and okay. It's absolutely true. Yeah.
I think you got to take yourself back to being a young activist. When I first learned about these ideas, I was very excited and I wanted to share them, and I did it all wrong. I was preaching about it. Where as you get older, you start to learn much better to shut your mouth, just say a little bit, listen, and then they'll ask you the questions when the time is right. Stop pushing.
That's absolutely true.
Exactly. Yeah,
and I think that comes with age and learning how to do it, because I don't blame it. I mean, all
it's
the new
hard to
activists
do that when
go
you're in a hurry.
And you're excited, you know?
Yeah, when you're in a hurry, you know, you want to get to freedom as quickly as possible. And so, you know, that advice can fall on deaf ears to somebody who's in that mindset.
It's hard, especially if they're brand new and a fire's lit under them, because I think that's kind of the path where...
That fire's lit under them, they're going to go burn some bridges.
then they go, you know, and of course they start with, like, their parents or something that, you know, the hardest people ever to convince.
I don't think I'm ever going to convince my mother.
Because you screwed it up when you were a kid, probably. You know, when you first got into it, I think that's real common. But the flip side is, I think as you get better and older at it, you say a little bit like Mark's talking about, and then just sit back, let them listen and ask questions.
Dax, anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
Just can't wait to finally move there next month.
Oh, yay! Next month. Wow, congratulations. Where are you going to end up?
We are buying a house in Manchester, actually.
Oh, wow, big
right
commitment.
In the city, huh?
Yeah, it was, you know... It was the best option for us.
Do you so about house buying? I kind of in this market, I wonder about buying houses. Not where you're buying it, because those are decisions you have to make for yourself. But do you have like a big dog, or you want to start a garden? I mean, what made you want to buy a house?
Because we can't really rent something that's going to fit. We're both going to be working from home, so we really need the space and a nice house. We couldn't get it. We looked in the country, but. The same price, we're getting checks. So
okay,
yeah, it's hard when you work for yourself. To nobody really wants to rent to you. I mean, without a steady like normal job.
I see what you're saying.
It's easier just to buy something. And plus, some of the prices here in New Hampshire, because I'm new here, you know, if you get a little out, it's much cheaper to just own the house than pay rent. The rent's kind of a little high some places.
It depends, yeah. It depends on where you are. Yeah, Dax, congratulations on that in advance. We'll look forward to seeing you here in New Hampshire, and thanks for the
call.
Come
to Keenvention.
Yeah, definitely. All right. Keenvention.info. Jared is on the line in Minnesota, the northern part of the state, listening to WNMT. Hey, Jared.
Hey.
Hi there. Go ahead.
I guess I just want to kind of talk about what got me onto the whole freedom thing was... I guess 20 years ago now, Ruby Ridge and Waco were huge. I'm watching the government kill people for no reason in Waco and murdering people at Ruby Ridge. And it was just kind of a wake up call. Like, wow, what is my government doing?
Yeah, that's scary stuff.
I watched that both of those things
in prison.
Yeah, I watched them in prison, and I didn't find. I guess I just looked at them like crazy people, you know. Like I'm just like, yeah, whatever, you know. Like people that wanted to get off by themselves. In the case of Ruby Ridge, must be something wrong with them. In the case of Waco, I'm just like, you know, religious nuts. And I didn't, for whatever reason, it just slid right past me. Now I was reading academic stuff on the ideas of liberty at the time through like Imprimis or Imprimis
magazine.
Didn't
connect though, huh?
Nah, but it wasn't. Not the real world.
Interesting.
Well, I remember that you just couldn't really get unfiltered media that easy back then. So a lot of the stuff I saw was like, oh, okay, these guys probably deserved it. They're shooting at cops. And then later on you learn, oh, no, they didn't. You know, that, the government were the bad guys.
At first glance, it's a bunch of, you know, zealots that are doing crazy things. And then you go, well, wait, they, you know, shoot his wife and his dog and you know, things like that. And it just kind of changed everything where I was going, why is the government attacking people? They could have picked them up at any time. And
yeah.
I think the warning sign is whenever they start calling something a compound.
Look out.
Yep. Yeah, that's the key word. Because, you know, anywhere
bring
else
it
would
bear
be
cat.
A farm.
Yeah.
But as soon as it's somebody the government doesn't
wasn't
like, it's a compound.
Koresh, didn't they want him because he didn't show up to court for something?
Yeah. I think so.
What was it that he was even supposed to be going to court for? I don't remember that detail of the case.
I think it might have been some kind of weapons charge.
I think he had guns without permits or something.
So no victim, yeah. No but crime.
No, there was no victim, no crime. And later on, there was nothing he was doing really illegal. They just
and
didn't
he jogged
like the
every morning. They could have just picked him up on his jog.
Yes, and they chose not to because they wanted to show their power and how tough they were.
Yeah.
By going into the compound instead of just picking him up quietly.
Yep.
And I guess one of the other things is with the weapons charge, there's only one thing that I need a permit for a right is a gun, and that doesn't make any sense. That I need a, I don't need a permit for the right to speak, but I need, for some reason, a permit for a gun, which is a right. So that doesn't make any sense.
No, and it doesn't make any sense just by the definition of the word. If you have a right, you don't have to ask permission to exercise the right.
Correct.
And a permit is evidence of asking for permission.
This is the greatest coup put upon the American people, and I think largely because of the government school system, is that, look, ladies and gentlemen, no, you cannot the government cannot attenuate rights. Because if they can attenuate them, they are not rights.
Yeah.
Rights, by their very definition, their definition is that you do not need permission to do it. Now, look, when you're talking about the right to freedom of speech, that doesn't mean you have the right to speak on somebody else's property. I can't go beneath Ian's window and yodel at 3 o'clock in the morning.
This is basic stuff people don't understand, Mark. I mean, a lot of people just, they think that they can't, you know, freedom of speech means being able to shout in a crowded theater or whatever. It's crazy.
Or that a piece of paper gives you rights.
Hey, Jared, anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
Well, I live on a five-building compound, so I guess I'll leave it at that.
Thanks, man, for the call tonight. I definitely appreciate hearing from you.
Do you guys remember, was there an event that really let you into liberty? Like
smoking pot for the first time.
Was that really?
Back
for real?
When I was 16.
That's what lit you up?
It was really important, so to speak. Yeah, it was really important for my development.
I didn't know all these things. I'm normal, right? Like, I don't need all this stuff, the extra things the Liberty Movement brings.
Whatever that means.
Well,
normal.
Ed and Elaine
went to
Brown.
Prison for 9 years. I don't know what that means.
I was just, look, man, I was already out of prison when I learned the ideas of liberty.
All right, there's more coming up here in moments. We got time for you if you want to join us at 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
You know what rubs millions of people the wrong way? Their thighs.
Shaq talks Gold Bond Friction Defense.
Skin friction is quite an affliction. On your legs, arms, whether you're running a 5K or just running upstairs.
And Gold Bond Friction Defense is
soothing.
Indeed. It's non-greasy, moisturizes, and helps like nobody's business.
Because your thighs rubbing together is nobody's business.
Gold Bond Friction Defense. Defense starts now.
Your thighs will thank you.
Oh boy.
I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, July 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.75 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,091 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $279. Antiwar.com reports Pentagon officials are claiming that Mohsen al-Fadli, an al-Qaeda figure who they accuse of being the leader of the Khorasan faction, was killed in a U.S. airstrike earlier this month in the Aleppo province of northern Syria. U.S. officials have claimed Fadli was the target of several previous airstrikes against al-Qaeda and had speculated in the past that he was killed. Al-Qaeda's Syria faction, Jabhat al-Nusra, has not indicated whether or not the Kuwaiti-born Fadli was targeted or killed. When U.S. airstrikes target al-Qaeda forces in Syria, they usually attribute them as Khorasan figures, though it is widely acknowledged that the term Khorasan is itself a U.S. manufacturer and primarily used to try to convince Syrian rebels that Nusra, a top rebel force, is not being targeted. The U.S. seems somewhat less concerned with targeting Nusra in the recent months, however, since there are fewer and fewer U.S. allies among the rebels to begin with, except for a tiny U.S.-created faction that the U.S. has dubbed the New Syrian Force. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports an appeals court on Tuesday overturned four of Rod Blagojevich's corruption convictions, a ruling that may or may not result in less prison time for the former Illinois governor. Blagojevich was convicted in 2011 on 18 counts of corruption charges, including trying to sell the U.S. Senate seat of President Barack Obama. He was sentenced to 14 years in prison at a facility in Colorado. Judges with the U.S. Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals overturned four of those convictions, saying that his attempt to appoint Valerie Jarrett in Obama's former Senate seat in exchange for a position on Obama's cabinet was a common exercise in log rolling. The ruling said this did not violate the law. In his appeal, Blagojevich's lawyers argued a number of errors were made by Judge James Zagel, including improperly instructing the jury about the law concerning fraud, extortion, and bribery. The overturned convictions could mean a reduction in sentencing for Blagojevich, though that may be unlikely. The Seventh Circuit Court's opinion said removing the four convictions does not affect the sentencing range. The judges also said Zagel's sentence in the first place was perhaps too lenient. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Facebook cannot challenge search warrants New York prosecutors used to get information from its site on hundreds of users suspected of Social Security fraud, according to a state appeals court on Tuesday, in a decision likely making it harder for New Yorkers to keep their digital lives private. The warrants, which applied to 381 users' photos, private messages, and other account information, could only be challenged by individual defendants after prosecutors gathered evidence, according to the Manhattan-based court. Facebook was backed in the case by a group of large internet companies, including Google and Microsoft, which argued the case could set a troubling precedent, giving prosecutors access to all kinds of digital information. Internet companies are pushing back broadly against U.S. intelligence and law enforcement agencies' demands for customer data in the wake of revelations by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden of wide-ranging online surveillance. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office served the warrants on Facebook in 2013, seeking information on dozens of people later indicted for Social Security fraud, including police officers and firefighters who allegedly feigned illness in the wake of the September 11, 2001 attacks. The world's biggest online social network turned the records over to prosecutors last year after a state judge threw out its claim that the warrants violated users' Fourth Amendment rights, but it also went ahead with the appeal. A Facebook spokesman said the company disagreed with the decision and was considering an appeal. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Tomorrow's my big day. I'm going to go in for surgery, and hopefully you'll come along. Now, I do have to admit that I am in a bit of pain, so I'm really looking forward to this procedure. I think we're both going to find out that having surgery just isn't as scary as it sounds.
we're covering our own Jim Haggerty's kidney stone removal surgery, and his surgery is now just minutes away. So, Dr. Atkins, tell us what precautions we would take to prevent us from getting kidney stones.
Always stay hydrated. Water helps the kidneys break the stuff down.
Hear that, Jim? More water.
What?
More water. Maybe we should replace your coffee.
Please go away.
That's a camera they're going to use to film the whole surgery from inside Jim's
body,
right?
Yes, that's
going to
be pushed into Jim's urethra as well. Now, normally they wouldn't do this. This is purely for the benefit of us watching it on TV.
All right, stick with us, because first he's going to pop into the children's ward to cheer up some youngsters suffering from terminal illnesses.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you can join us here. Toll-free number, whether you want to talk about persuasion. How do you persuade people to the ideas of freedom? In fact, there's a really great book that Michael Cloud wrote. He's one of the libertarian activists. He was actually the campaign manager for Harry Brown's campaign. You mentioned Harry Brown earlier, Tarrin. Harry Brown was the Libertarian Party presidential candidate in the year 1996 and 2000. And Michael Cloud wrote Secrets of Libertarian Persuasion. It actually used to be an audio cassette.
Audiobook.
And I actually had, back in the day, I actually had the audio cassette version of that. And it's a great book. So I recommend that. The folks from the Advocates for Self-Government are the publishers of that. So if you want to go and get that, I think it's available through theadvocates.org.
I'd also like to plug Mary Ruart's update on that. She has a, what is it called?
Tough questions, simple answers.
Short answers.
Short answers to tough questions.
That's what it is, yes.
And that is a really good book to, if you can just, you know, read the main questions. What about the roads? What about, you know, how do we get along without police? And she's got answers that are basically boiled down to about a paragraph that if you just read them and you're new to the movement, it lets you communicate very complicated ideas simply. I just love that book.
She's a brilliant communicator. There's no doubt about it. In fact, she just gave a speech at the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance. They have a yearly
Liberty Dinner.
I've been to a couple of these over the years. I haven't gone, I don't think, in the last year or two. I don't think I went to last year's.
I've been to a couple, maybe three, and I don't know that I've ever seen you at one.
Well, I don't know, Mark. I've been to at least two. I can tell you that.
I'll take your word for it.
That was my first. I was excited.
It's like a, it's kind of a, you know,
it's a formal shindig.
More formal. I don't think it's, I don't think there's an actual dress code, is there? I think it's just like,
no, I just
people
think
tend
that,
to dress for it.
That, you know, the Liberty Movement doesn't have many events that you get to dress up for. So
yeah,
people,
so they do.
So
they
people
do.
Enjoy this because you get to actually throw on and look, you know, get pictures.
It's a nice event. There are maybe 100 or 200 people or something like that. And they, you know, they've got it in a big dining room kind of thing. And there's awards given out. Daryl Perry got an award this year. Actually, he's our Friday night co-host. He was given an award for being one of the most prolific Bill reviewers,
yes.
Meaning that what the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance does, this doesn't happen anywhere else, by the way. If I'm wrong about that, please call to correct us at 855-450-FREE. But I believe there is no organization, no political organization, at the very least within the United States, that is like the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance that does what they do. What they do, among other things, in the case of Daryl, is they have this group of volunteers, probably dozens of volunteers. I don't know how many exactly, but a lot of people, who will read through every piece of legislation, or as many as physically can be done. And there's like 800 pieces of legislation.
It's not
in New
always
Hampshire.
Every piece, but it's 800 to 1,000 pieces of legislation.
That's how many there are filed. Now, they try to read through as many as they possibly can. It just depends on how many volunteers they have. And they usually, I think they come close. I'm not sure.
They often do. And I'm just saying that they get the lion's share of legislation and all the important stuff.
They actually read through, which is an awful task. I mean, if you've ever tried reading the law before, my God, it's horribly boring and really difficult in some cases to read it. At least for me, that's my encounter with statutes and things like that. So he actually reads through these things, and these dozens of other folks do too. And then they grade the legislation. They rank it based on a variety of different factors. Does this, and I'm boiling it down, but you know, there's different questions they're asked about it. But ultimately, it comes down to, does this legislation help freedom, or does it hurt freedom, or is it sort of middle of the road? And so they grade it based on these different factors, and then ultimately, and there's, you can actually have more than one person read a piece of legislation, so maybe Daryl would grade it slightly differently than another reader of it. So he was awarded because he actually was like one of the top three.
he was probably number one, but he's the top three of the most reader, like the most reading people. He read the most legislation this year compared to the rest of their volunteers. And they need more volunteers, by the way.
Hats off to Daryl, man. That is something that would be... I could maybe read a bill or two. I don't know how someone does...
Well, they would. They could use your help. I mean, and this is something... Sometimes people call Tarrin and they'll ask us, hey, I'm not in New Hampshire. I might or might not move there. What can I do to help? And, and besides, you know, the sort of the standard answer is, well, you can give money to the organizations that you support. That's an easy one. But this is one that you can, if you don't have money to give, you can put your time into this. You don't have to live in New Hampshire to be able to read a piece of proposed legislation that is proposed for New Hampshire and then grade it based on this really easy system. It's really cool.
And just rating the bills in and of itself is huge. But what we need to understand that also the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance endorses candidates.
That's right.
They had 78, I believe, candidates, so about 80 candidates. You're talking about 20% of the legislature is endorsed by the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance.
That I've been endorsed by them.
That means that they are nominally libertarian. Now, you didn't have a snowball's chance in hell, but 78 out of 128 or something like that won. And that means that they're having a real effect. They have, in effect, a libertarian veto.
Not quite.
It doesn't work the same way as a veto, but 20% of the legislatures, I mean, most bills don't pass by that margin.
Yeah.
So if you have your conservative bill or your liberal bill, in order to get it through, it has to go through... you know, this group of legislators that are liberty oriented.
It's not a it's not like a gauntlet though or anything like that. It's not an impossible task to get things through. Unfortunately, we still need more people to move here. We need more liberty activists here to actually make it into a libertarian veto. It's nice. It's a good thing to have. And there's a lot of stuff that passes in other states that doesn't pass here. So like the license plate scanners that 49 out of 50 states have, the police where they've got these crazy boxes on their car that scans license plates as they're driving around, or they've got them on the side of the road. These are really kind of creepy Orwellian police state kind of things. New Hampshire rejected those at the legislative level last year. Unfortunately, you know, like I said, it's not perfect. So one of the things New Hampshire did do, which I think was really poor, was they passed a handheld driving ban. So right now that actually just went into effect, and it's pretty outrageous, and that needs to go away. So hopefully we'll see a push to repeal that at some point. It's not a perfect libertarian veto, not yet. We need thousands more people to move here and get active as part of the Free State Project. And by the way, there was a milestone that passed relatively quietly. I didn't see much fanfare about this. Free State Project crossed 17,000. Very recently.
I didn't see that.
Didn't know that either.
I think they're waiting for 17.5 because that's a little more significant.
It's 85% right now.
I'm just saying.
That's huge.
You know, it just seems more significant as far as the number goes.
Why would that be more significant? You know, 17,000 is a nice round number.
85% is awesome.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's awesome. So congratulations, Free State Project. How long will it take us to close the gap and get to 20,000 signers, 20,000 people who have pledged to make the move to New Hampshire, as the three of us have done and as over 1,500 other people have
done? The website says 987. Excuse me, 16,987.
Oh, no. Where did I see that? I thought, okay.
It's going to happen soon.
All right, hey, three people need to sign up during this show.
13 people, right?
Yeah, 13 people.
Okay, sorry.
So, yeah. If you want,
I went to government school.
Yeah, if you want to be part of history, maybe I saw something that was like a preview for it. Maybe they were like preparing for it or something. I take it back. I apologize. So, I guess I should have gone and checked the actual number rather than trusting Facebook.
One thing I saw an activist post online that I think is kind of interesting, though, is that there's 17,000 people in state. 1,700, excuse me, people in state.
That's correct.
Almost 1,800 people in state for the Free State Project. And then there's another 2,500 that are friends of the Free State.
That's correct, yeah.
That means that we have 4,000 people in state. And
who have taken the 4,000 people who have taken the time to go to the Free State Project website and go through some kind of a sign-up form.
Yep.
So there's even more people who are friendly to the Free State Project who have not done that.
Right, because you're not going to move 20,000 people to a state of 1.4 million and take over. That's kind of ridiculous. What you can do is you can go there, you can get active, you can provide support for the locals that believe like you do, and you can have a real effect. One thing that I found convincing and interesting is that... if you look at how many activists there are in the political process.
Like Republican and Democrat?
Republican and Democrat. You'll find that maybe there's about 500 Democrat activists and about 500 Republican activists and about 500 Liberty activists. That means that we bring something to the table, as Republicans and Democrats, because mm-hmm. liberty activists run as both, we bring something to the table that, you know, as far as numbers, we're right there alongside. We're an equal participant, because it's not Mr. and Mrs. Beer Can voter out there. You know, ladies and gentlemen, if all you do is vote, your significance in the political process is minute.
Yeah, that's true.
It's the people who are inside, you know, the political system.
The people
working.
Who go to the state house, yeah. The people who go to city council and town council meetings and things like that. And Free Staters are more likely than not to be involved in things like that. And you can join the fun. Go to freestateproject.org. And if you want to help with the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, their website, nhliberty.org, you can help review bills from afar. That's not a problem. They would love your and appreciate your assistance. We got more Free Talk Live coming up.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phones, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Welcome back to more Free Talk Live. We have time for you to share your thoughts with us. We've been talking about persuasion, also, you know, how to persuade people to the ideas of liberty, the Free State Project, and some of the cool stuff that's happening up here in New Hampshire with not even yet 2,000 people having made the move here. We're only of about 1,500 that have early moved to the Free State Project. You can go to freestateproject.org to learn more about that. Also, ExpressCoin, the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And over at ExpressCoin.com, they're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check. Start off at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. You can do it from their website or grab their smartphone app at expresscoin.com and use coupon code FTL when you're checking out. You'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee whatsoever. So go to expresscoin.com with coupon code FTL. You buy more than $40, it's only a 3% fee, which is an awesome deal to exchange currencies. So go to expresscoin.com and don't forget coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. Mark, where are we at in this story here from the Freeman's perspective? It's a blog. He is sharing with us some suggestions as to how best to approach people and communicate the ideas of freedom to them.
About halfway through, he's asking this question regarding the government and why it's okay for the government to use force to get what it wants and not for the average person. He says, why then is the same idea holy and glorious when applied to brigands and deceivers in the form of the government, as it has been for some 6,000 years?
And the idea he's referring to would be like if your neighbor came over and said, hey, I need some money to send my kid to school, and then put a gun in your face. Like, you'd see that as pretty obviously wrong for someone to do that. So he's asking, why is it okay when it's the people calling themselves the government effectively doing the same thing? Not as directly, but through a number of different threatening letters and things like that, they effectively do the same thing. They use the threat of force.
Yeah, and the state has been around perhaps 6,000, certainly 6,000, perhaps even farther back than that. The usual response to such a question is, by the way, is this, the sound of crickets. And please notice that this, yes, because people can't answer this question. People, they might have a utilitarian argument that if we don't have this band of brigands and thieves,
this is the price we pay for society, Mark. We need to do this.
Right. As though somehow civility is enhanced by one organization having a monopoly privilege on theft and violence. That enhances civility, society, civil society. And please notice that this is precisely the way to phrase things to the brainwash. You have to create moments of clarity. Sometimes it'll work and a seed will be planted. Other times, they'll hate your guts for forcing them to see, forcing them into punishable thoughts. Mm. And these thoughts are punishable. Like, these are outlying thoughts. The idea that one group of people does not have the right to use force and violence to get what they want, that is an outlying thought. That is statism in its encapsulated form. I know that Mark Levin will tell you all kinds of things about statism, but the guy doesn't know anything about statism.
Hmm.
He believes that a document signed by a few dead men from 200 and something years ago somehow binds you to behavior. The Constitution, my friends, is not a contract, because it didn't contract you. At least if it is a contract, it is not a contract with you, because you didn't get to sign it. You never had an option. The social contract, as they call it, there is no social contract. They'll change the social contract anytime that they want. Mm-hmm. They don't send you a terms of service.
Right. The social contract is whatever they say goes. That's what it is.
That's exactly what it is. And if you don't like it, we'll kill you.
Right.
I don't care how trite this may sound, but the right way to get through to the brainwashed is simply to love them. Loving them means that you have to get over the need to win, to prove yourself right. Get clear on the facts. If you're promoting personal liberty, true free will, true free speech, and so on, you're already right. You don't have to prove anything. When you try to prove your rightness, you get dragged down into their winning game and you slide into their pit, because you don't want to be in a situation where you're winning or losing, because nobody wants to lose. Mm-hmm. So they're not going to lose a debate to you. Tell me where you have ever watched a debate — most people don't watch debates — but where you've ever watched a debate where one side says, you know what, you're right. If you're dealing with a side like that, you're dealing with an extraordinary individual, an extraordinarily honest individual.
Yeah, once in a while you see one of the flame wars, you know, where somebody takes the high road on Facebook. You know, this is where you see debates is Facebook. And I'm always impressed when that person comes out and can own up to it, but it's rare.
Never see
Man,
that.
It's rare.
I've been convinced of like one thing on Facebook ever. You know, like it's just, you know, usually in debates, it's just very rare. I did post, interestingly, a video from Adam Kokesh that occurred.
With the veteran, right?
Some musclehead, in a bar, I guess. And Kokesh, it's on Facebook at facebook.freetalklive.com. Just scroll down till you see it. And he does a great job in talking to this guy who's looking to pound him into the dirt.
Right.
Right?
Because he was talking bad about America or something, right?
Yeah. Well, that's the... Okay, he didn't hear him say anything. He just heard, you know, down the line of thing. And so, you know, you got something bad to say about America, I'm going to pound you into the dirt. And that's useful, pal. Really?
And he de-escalated the situation, right?
He de-escalated it, but he did it in a fashion that did not budge on his point.
And gave him something to think about.
Yeah, absolutely. He, you know, the guy was willing to agree that veterans are treated terribly, and I agree with him. Veterans aren't the cause as much as they're the victim.
It's true.
You'd be amazed how fast things can turn if you can find common ground. Like, you'll see people yelling at each other, and if you can be like, you know, I get that point and I agree with you, and give them a win, man, they change their whole attitude. If you let someone win,
that's a good point.
Yeah, sometimes. And it's just like we said earlier, it's those new Liberty people that are so high energized that must win. And I think there's something with like this community where we just got a lot of people that have to be right, you know, and I don't know if that's necessarily.
It certainly helped that he did have in common with the guy that he also is a veteran. So Adam Kokesh has spent time in the military.
That's true. But did you watch the video?
I watched some of it, and he was getting picked on because he wasn't like as much of a battle veteran or something
right,
like that.
Right. He was civil something was the terminology. And basically, I don't know what that means, but he saw some combat. But he apparently didn't see enough combat for the musclehead. Right. And, you know, whatever. There's always somebody who saw more combat than you. Are we saying that only Green Berets get to have an opinion?
We got one of those too. Silver Dave is a former Green Beret.
Yeah, fine.
It blows me away how many military people are in the Liberty movement that I had no idea, like Dale or something, you know? Or
yeah, that's right.
And
Dale was Don't Ask, Don't Tell, though. Wasn't he?
Was he?
I don't recall.
Kicked out of the Navy for because of Don't Ask, Don't Tell or something. Got caught in some situation.
Yeah, it just I'm surprised.
There's a lot of them. Well, I mean, that's because
they get it.
They know because they've been on the inside. I mean, you know how inefficient government is once you start working for them, right? You start to see what it's really like.
I mean, I was talking to these guys, and they're told, you know, hey, I'm fighting for freedom and liberty, and, you know, freedom's not free. And then they tell me, well, I got shipped over to Garden Opium Field for, you know, 6 months.
Or Puke and the gang talked about how, you know, there's, of course, getting the military and there's all this propaganda about their commercials and everything and making it look all badass. And he's sweeping, I think he described it as sweeping dirt in the desert. He was like sweeping dirt off of an airfield in the desert. So we'll come back with more here. You can share your thoughts.
It's a force for good.
855-450-FREE. And we'll continue. Also, Skype in at username lrn.fm. This is Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back. More Free Talk Live right now. Time for you if you want to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Tarrin is here with us tonight. Ian and Mark in the studio as normal. And Tarrin, you've got a website, but you've just kind of got it back online.
Yeah,
You do have a YouTube channel as well, though, which
right.
People can find by searching for your name, Tarrin Lupo. That's L-U-P-O, Lupo, T-A-R-R-I-N, Tarrin. You'll find his, what we used to be called the LCL report, but I guess you can't really call it that anymore because you don't live in the low country.
Unless I can somehow spin it to match something up here, if I can make it an acronym. But I'm just trying to change it over to Tarrin Lupo because it's more than just activism on there. There's also, you know, a little, I've been recently trying to plug things I'm doing in New Hampshire to show people who are interested in moving up what these small towns are like.
It's like a slice of life kind of thing, right?
Yeah.
Like this is what's happening here in your area
spotlighting,
where you moved to. You moved to the Peterborough area, which is a little town between, not a small town. I guess on the scale of New Hampshire, it's like 6,000, so maybe about a fourth of the size of Keene, for instance.
Right.
You actually went to Dublin Days? What was it?
Dublin. All I knew about Dublin is that's where you always got pulled over and got tickets.
Okay.
Because the speed limit's like 30 in Dublin.
Yeah.
So I went to their little festival, and I made a short video about it. You can find it on the Free Talk Live Facebook page, right?
I just posted it up there earlier tonight. Yeah,
yep.
It's up there.
And it's called Dublin Days. If you kind of want to get an idea of the small town stuff here, I'm a small town guy. I'm not a big city manch person. I like small town life. And my stories, a lot of them are going to focus on some smaller towns. But I'd appreciate if you'd swing by and take a look.
So what, I mean, what kind of things happen at Dublin Days? Is it like cows and 4-H?
Yeah, kind of.
You know?
They had a free petting zoo, of course, okay. Which is like bribery. As soon as you get in, everybody rushes to the free petting zoo. But what I thought was interesting is they had a 100-year-old ice cream machine.
Whoa.
And it was like steam driven. It was like one that you hear a thud, 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 thud. And it's
and they
on
were
the video.
Making ice cream.
And they made ice cream with this old churn. And
did you get
it was
some?
So
did you try
good.
Some?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, it was cool. Ridiculous.
They have things like that in New Hampshire all over the place. I mean, they actually,
every
there's a market in antique tractors here. And I just don't get it. I do not get it. I'm like, oh, wow. Hallelujah.
Here's do they work or do they just sit there?
Yes, in many cases they do.
Okay.
Well, they work like old cars work. And yeah. Having had a 76 Eldorado convertible, work is a really optimistic term for what it did, because it did that often enough that you looked cool, but not often enough that you always looked cool. You look pretty not cool parked on the side of the road, even if you do have a 76 Eldorado convertible.
Yeah, it's worth to watch the story just for that, to see this cool
ice cream machine. Okay,
but then there's also a barbershop quartet, you know, like the old-timey guys that walk around and sing. So there was a lot going on in this little town. New Hampshire's really cool. There's events like this every weekend.
Check him out on YouTube, Tarrin Lupo. As we go to your calls and thoughts, then we can talk more about persuasion, how to share the ideas of freedom more effectively with folks. Michael is in Redwood, California. You're on Free Talk Live. Michael.
Oh, hi.
Welcome. Go ahead.
Yes. I just heard you talking while I was on the phone waiting, and you said freedom isn't free. Well, what if you use deferments to go to school instead of going to fight for this country, like so many people did? Or if you use a medical condition to stay out of going to war, but it doesn't keep you from living your life and playing tennis and running and jogging or doing whatever else that you do. I mean, in that perspective, freedom is free. If you...
Do we say freedom isn't free?
I threw it out as a colloquialism.
Oh,
to,
I see.
Of what, you know, I always hear the argument, well, freedom's not free. But I disagree with that, because I don't feel that someone can earn my freedom.
I don't know if freedom is free. I think that generally you're going to have to stand your ground in order to get it. But I would question anybody who claims the United States military has provided us with freedom. You know, maybe we can go back as far as sort of you can make an argument sort of for the colonial military that fought against England. But, you know, there's not much.
Yeah, definitely. But what about Pearl Harbor? I mean, because my uncles went to fight in World War II, and one died out there, and the other came back in a wheelchair for the last 50 years of his life. And
The war against Japan was a war for control of the Pacific, sort of the Pacific Rim. It wasn't a war to keep you free. Do you think that Japan was going to invade the United States?
Well, they certainly did a good job of attacking Pearl Harbor.
They didn't do that in a vacuum, though. I mean, that was a dispute over the
Roosevelt's policy.
Yeah, oil embargoes.
Roosevelt was trying his hardest to get Japan to attack us, and basically thumbed his nose at him with some policies on oil, which drove them to attack. So it's not like the U.S. was innocent and we just got attacked for no reason.
Well, nobody knows how far Japan and Germany would have gone if they would have continued with their winning ways.
Well, you can only go so far because you only have so many troops to occupy territory, right? I mean, if Germany was already occupying, what was it, Poland and a few other places at that time.
At that point, they were just about to go to war with Russia, too.
Yeah.
I mean, they can't spread too thin.
Your resources so far,
Well, it's tough, buddy, because, you know, all of us probably have some sort of military in our back, you know, in our family somewhere. Like, my grandpa was a military, and I love him.
My dad kept Iowa safe during the Korean War.
That's it. and it's hard because you have, you know, a personal vested interest, but as a whole, it's hard to justify what happened as to keep me free. You know, Roosevelt drove that to happen. He caused less freedom, not more.
And created a lot of social programs, too.
Yeah.
But that's just a perspective of yours. I don't know what the truth is, you know, and I never looked at it like that, you know. So, I don't know what to say. It's like when I had a classmate say that Bush knew about those 9/11 attacks. And, you know, and as much as I dislike Bush and I really do not like him, I was just horrified that she would say something like that.
I know it's tough
to
hear.
Just her perspective. It's just her perspective, and there's no truth in it.
What is just your perspective? I'm sorry, just to be clear, when you're saying, Michael, that it's just your perspective, what are you referring to exactly?
Well, how you look at things, you know, because you
specifically
may look at what do you mean typically what?
Specifically.
Oh, no, he's talking about Roosevelt. Roosevelt actually, you know,
you
a night before
Roosevelt,
Pearl Harbor happened, they were intercepting signals off the coast, so they knew the attack was coming.
The McCollum memo as well.
The McCollum memo is
not a perspective. I mean, that's written down. You can read it. I think it's 8 points, basically, on how to manipulate the Japanese into attacking the United States, if I'm recalling correctly.
It's historical fact.
Yeah, just an opinion, Michael.
Right.
Those reports that you're talking about, how do you know they're not, you know, scared towards those people who want to make that claim? You know,
are you claiming that the McCollum memo is
fake? The actual pieces of paper.
I don't know. I really don't know.
I know, I didn't know about it either. I mean, World War II seems like the most legitimate of wars in the last 100 years, doesn't it? But, I mean, the fact is World War II was created by World War I. If Wilson would have stuck to his principles and said that and not gotten the U.S. into World War I, then Hitler would have never risen to power because there never would have been a Treaty of Versailles. There might have been a conflict with Japan over the Pacific Rim, but we can look at the McCollum memo, which is actual history, and it's not disputed by anybody. And then we can say, oh, well, in fact, the United States did have a diplomatic role. I mean, we just recently got some information that a few years before that, I mean, like 6 years before that, the Roosevelt administration was putting together plans to attack Canada. I mean, this is just how insane these people are.
Hey, Michael, thanks for the call. If you want to look up more about the McCollum memo. What I would recommend that you do, Michael, is check out McCollum Memo on Wikipedia. That's a good place to start. And I'll post a link on our Facebook and our Twitter for those of you who'd like to actually read the full text of said memo.
If you want to continue believing that the World War II was a completely just war on the part of the United States, do not read the McCollum Memo. Keep your head buried in the sand.
All right, so we'll come back. We've got a full segment remaining, which means there's enough time for you if you want to join us here. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. We also have Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. We're coming up here on Free Talk Live. And, of course, you can join us online anytime over at freetalklive.com. Your call's next.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Our digital freedom is under attack.
Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget freeross.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you may dial toll-free here to join us at 855-450-FREE. Get your thoughts in the remaining moments of the program. We've been talking about sharing the ideas of liberty more successfully. What are some of the tactics you can use to better communicate these concepts to people you care about or just total strangers? And there are better tactics than others, and we never really got through the full story, right, Mark? Maybe in the last, we've got like a quarter left or something like that. Did you post this already on our Facebook page?
I did, actually.
Excellent. So those of you who would like to get the full story of what we've been sharing portions of here tonight, you can just go to our Facebook or our Twitter. They are both there, so go there and enjoy that. They're all totally free, and you can start by going to news.freetalklive.com. You can link to our Twitter and our Facebook from our news.freetalklive.com page, and further, you can also sign up for our email list where you will get emailed updates about the latest with Free Talk Live. All of that is over at news.freetalklive.com. As we go to your calls and thoughts, we got Chris. He's in Alstead, New Hampshire. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys, how are you tonight?
Hey, what's on your mind?
Oh, I've just been having fun this week playing, doing guard duty in Keene, New Hampshire.
Yes, that's right. We talked a little bit about this last night, I think, on the program, or the night before. I don't remember which one it was, but you have been making headlines here in New Hampshire, at least in the Keene area, and this has been going on, I guess, in other cities, where after the shooting that happened in, I think it was Tennessee, a few days back, Oathkeepers like yourself, Chris, have come out to military recruiting centers, which are apparently places where the military men are prohibited from carrying weapons to defend themselves. And you have stood in defense of those defenseless individuals as sort of a statement of these gun-free zones are terrible ideas. Is that right, Chris?
Absolutely. And particularly in the case in Keene, it's not just recruiters. There's also private businesses that are in the same building, but they're all behind the door that says no guns allowed here.
Oh, really?
Absolutely. Second floor, there's people up there that just have regular businesses.
Wow.
You've got cleaning people and stuff like that that, you know, work in there too, and they were the first ones who came out the door going, thank you so much for being here and doing this. But
awesome.
It's really been, you're talking a little bit about how to get the message out there in different ways. I mean, that's what it's been for me, and it's just really interesting because a lot of people that support us are pretty much Republican. You know, they're pretty much dyed in the wool, and they kind of have always gone with sort of the party line. They understand some of the aspects of liberty, but it's interesting to talk to them about, you know, legalization of heroin.
And you've been doing
engage
that?
Engage them in a conversation. Absolutely. Engage them in a conversation.
That's awesome.
About, you know, who owns your body. And, you know, we had one vet who had heard about these people called Free Keen. He was from Claremont, and he's like, you know, what if, I'll tell you, one of them shows up and burns a flag. I'm like, well, you know, let's talk about that. Let's talk about the First Amendment. Let's talk about freedom of speech and talk about the fact that that's been declared even by the Supreme Court, something he understood, that is an example of free speech. And, you know, talk about
it's supposed to be what the military's fighting for.
Well, that was what was really interesting to try to convey. And under the circumstances, you know, where you all have a common goal, where you're all there for pretty much the same reason, maybe with different motives. But it was really, I think, a really productive way to have some of those conversations. You know,
yeah, this is the way that you get. This is the way it's done. So the Free State Project is a project to move 20,000 liberty-loving individuals to one state, but to move there and sort of be an enclave where you sort of hurl insults at people who aren't necessarily the on board with your ideas, that's never going to work. What works is getting involved in the community and working with people who are not principled and talking to them about the ideas of liberty. On the fire department, I've had many opportunities to talk to people about my ideas. And, you know, I don't know how effective they've been, but as time goes by, we inch by inch, you get your ideas across.
Yeah, I think by actually volunteering to be productive in a community, going out and volunteering to help like you're doing,
they're
going to think twice about, you know, oh, I didn't realize that guy's a free stater. I guess they're not all crazy. You know, this guy's volunteering all the time.
Yeah, the more people that move here for the Free State Project, the more different areas of interest they're going to go and spend their time. So, like, you know, Tarrin, you like to go to the old farm things that we were just talking about.
But being a good neighbor is activism.
No, I think to some extent it can be, as long as you're communicating over time with people. But, you know, you go to different things that Chris is going to go to, then I'm going to go to, and going to get involved in different clubs and organizations and things like that. And eventually, even if somebody sees something they don't like, because somebody might see what you're doing, Chris, and they might decide that that's not good activism, or, you know, you might have you had anybody drive by and yell, get a job at you yet?
Oh, you're not even from here. I bet you don't even pay taxes. It was pretty good. And this guy who was yelling that, well, honestly, it's like he pulled up, he stopped in the middle of the street, he looked at all of us and goes, I could have killed you all from right here.
Whoa.
I'm like, really? And this is like, you know, this is a keen local, I'm assuming liberal.
Mm.
I'm sitting there going, yeah, you've got one former Army guy and two Marines with AR-15s who have done tours in Iraq and Afghanistan. I think the odds are against you, my friend.
Was he suggesting he was going to run you down with his car?
I have no idea, but those guys got the biggest smiles from all of us. We were always courteous, polite. That was one thing we really stressed. Courteous, polite, smile.
Just goes to show, it doesn't matter what your issue is, anybody standing out and doing kind of, you know, some kind of public activism is going to be hated. There are going to be people who shout at you, who are rude to you, and who don't appreciate what you're doing. But on the other hand, there's been a bunch of people who've stopped by. They brought you water. You've even had members of the Keene Police Department come by and, you know, shake your hand, that kind of thing, right?
Oh, yeah, offer. The Keene Police have been by every time. They say, can we go get you anything? Do you need water? Do you guys need anything? We actually had to, one of the gentlemen who's helping out owns a local business, and we're using his storeroom to contain all the water, all the Gatorade, all the food. We've got gift cards. We've got cash. We've got home-cooked meals today. It was amazing. Cards, gifts. It's insane.
Let me share a little advice with you that kind of worked. There's a guy, Ernest Hancock, who had a similar situation go down where they were banning firearms. And what they figured out how to do was they sent a letter of notice to the company that owns it and basically said that, you know, if you're going to disarm us on your premises, then you are you're responsible for defending our lives. And if something happens to us, you're liable. And all of a sudden, they took down the sign and let everybody carry firearms again. You know, you might want to try that tactic too, because it has had success with basically, you know, they never look at it as they're disarming people. But
right.
if they're willing to disarm you, then you know what? They just took responsibility for your life.
Absolutely.
Anything else you want to share about your experience thus far, Chris? It's been going, what, how many days have you been out there now?
This was the third day today. We plan on keeping going. I know there's been some talk about the military sending out memos saying, make these people feel uncomfortable. We
really?
Want them out. Yeah, yeah. Marines and the Army, a couple memos have been leaked out.
Oh, wow.
Might have to come film you guys. Where, are you going to be out there for another day or two?
We hope so. I'm going to be talking with the recruiters tomorrow to see if they're getting a lot of heat from them. And from day one, they've been supportive. They're like, they started out with, we can't stop you, but then it's been, they've spent a lot of time talking with us, stuff like that. Military wives coming by saying, you cannot imagine how much better we feel with you guys keeping our husband safe. It's
isn't this really
overwhelming.
PR, though? I mean, the guy that did this was sort of acting like a lone wolf. I mean, what's the likelihood of this occurring again, with or without armed guards? I mean, isn't this just
it's
sort
total
of
PR, in my opinion. But go ahead, Chris.
Well,
you can answer the question.
It could be. But you also consider that, you know, since 9/11, and I'm re-quoting something that I've heard, and I can't back it up, but 21 attacks on military personnel in the United States since 9/11.
Okay.
So when you think about a Fort Hood, you think about the Navy shipyards down in D.C., you talk about attacks on recruiting stations, things like that. It may not be that far-fetched. You know, I don't go out in Keene, New Hampshire, and expect to get a drive-by from a bunch of crazed Islamic radicals or anything like that. But I don't know. There is some level of threat there, and that's why the majority of people have showed up to volunteer.
It's an outreach project, I think, first and foremost. I mean, because anybody who's really serious about killing military recruiters will simply follow them home, or they will, you know, wait until you guys go away. I mean, really.
Yeah.
So, but it's a cool act of symbolism, and this is a world of symbolism. So this is one that's having an impact on people, and kudos to you, Chris, for going out there, because it's hot out there, by the way, when they're out there doing this stuff right now. And thanks for the call tonight. We'll see you tomorrow online. In the meantime, at Free Talk Live, check out Tarrin on YouTube.
Following today's press conference in which NASA announced its continuing search for a planet capable of supporting NASA, researcher Dr. Kenneth Heiser sat down with Onion reporters to detail their ongoing mission to find a NASA habitable planet.
Our objective is to find a planet capable of nurturing not just life, but also a sustained interest in the exploration of the cosmos. Such a planet would need to have water and proximity to light and heat, but also life forms with even the vaguest understanding of the importance of astronomical exploration. Ultimately, this would need to be a planet with organisms that have a genuine interest in expanding the limits of their knowledge.
Heiser added that any planet capable of supporting NASA would need to be able to generate a steady stream of financing to meet the agency's $18 billion annual budget.
The important thing is we just need to be patient. There's a limitless number of planets in the universe, and eventually we'll find one with the resources to support our work. We just have to, right?
This is the Onion News Network.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Cop Block Radio is next, after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, July 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.75 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,091 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $279. Antiwar.com reports Pentagon officials are claiming that Mohsen al-Fadli, an al-Qaeda figure who they accuse of being the leader of the Khorasan faction, was killed in a U.S. airstrike earlier this month in the Aleppo province of northern Syria. U.S. officials have claimed Fadli was the target of several previous airstrikes against al-Qaeda and had speculated in the past that he was killed. Al-Qaeda's Syria faction, Jabhat al-Nusra, has not indicated whether or not the Kuwaiti-born Fadli was targeted or killed. When U.S. airstrikes target al-Qaeda forces in Syria, they usually attribute them as Khorasan figures, though it is widely acknowledged that the term Khorasan is itself a U.S. manufacturer and primarily used to try to convince Syrian rebels that Nusra, a top rebel force, is not being targeted. The U.S. seems somewhat less concerned with targeting Nusra in the recent months, however, since there are fewer and fewer U.S. allies among the rebels to begin with, except for a tiny U.S.-created faction that the U.S. has dubbed the New Syrian Force. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports an appeals court on Tuesday overturned four of Rod Blagojevich's corruption convictions, a ruling that may or may not result in less prison time for the former Illinois governor. Blagojevich was convicted in 2011 on 18 counts of corruption charges, including trying to sell the U.S. Senate seat of President Barack Obama. He was sentenced to 14 years in prison at a facility in Colorado. Judges with the U.S. Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals overturned four of those convictions, saying that his attempt to appoint Valerie Jarrett in Obama's former Senate seat in exchange for a position on Obama's cabinet was a common exercise in log rolling. The ruling said this did not violate the law. In his appeal, Blagojevich's lawyers argued a number of errors were made by Judge James Zagel, including improperly instructing the jury about the law concerning fraud, extortion, and bribery. The overturned convictions could mean a reduction in sentencing for Blagojevich, though that may be unlikely. The Seventh Circuit Court's opinion said removing the four convictions does not affect the sentencing range. The judges also said Zagel's sentence in the first place was perhaps too lenient. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Facebook cannot challenge search warrants New York prosecutors used to get information from its site on hundreds of users suspected of Social Security fraud, according to a state appeals court on Tuesday, in a decision likely making it harder for New Yorkers to keep their digital lives private. The warrants, which applied to 381 users' photos, private messages, and other account information, could only be challenged by individual defendants after prosecutors gathered evidence, according to the Manhattan-based court. Facebook was backed in the case by a group of large internet companies, including Google and Microsoft, which argued the case could set a troubling precedent, giving prosecutors access to all kinds of digital information. Internet companies are pushing back broadly against U.S. intelligence and law enforcement agencies' demands for customer data in the wake of revelations by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden of wide-ranging online surveillance. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office served the warrants on Facebook in 2013, seeking information on dozens of people later indicted for Social Security fraud, including police officers and firefighters who allegedly feigned illness in the wake of the September 11, 2001 attacks. The world's biggest online social network turned the records over to prosecutors last year after a state judge threw out its claim that the warrants violated users' Fourth Amendment rights, but it also went ahead with the appeal. A Facebook spokesman said the company disagreed with the decision and was considering an appeal. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Terror and confusion fell upon the nation this week after nearly 314 million Americans reported inexplicably losing consciousness for 8 hours straight last night, with countless victims helplessly recovering from the fugue-like state with no memory whatsoever of the lost time. Researchers at Princeton University, who have been studying the alarming phenomenon since its inception, told reporters that though they were unable to ascertain the source of the sweeping condition, it appeared to be somehow linked to the setting of the sun.
Right now, we suspect that there may be some connection between these sudden blackouts and the visions that some Americans have reported experiencing while they were unconscious. But most of these hallucinations are too abstract for us to draw any definite conclusions from.
At this time, we urge people to never turn off their lights and under no circumstances close their eyes for any extended period of...
Oh, God. It's happening again.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome to Cop Block Radio. We're live. It's Wednesday, July 15th, 2015. I am Derek J, broadcasting from Theme, New Hampshire. And across the internet, we've got Dio.
Dio here, broadcasting from Ohio.
Meow. How you doing, Dio?
Pretty good. You?
Feeling safe, feeling good, not contacted by any government agents. How about you?
Not me neither.
All right, good.
Went and contacted some myself, but,
Oh, well, all right. I want to hear about that. On the line, we have, are you a government agent, Chris?
I am. I am a government agent.
Oh, no.
Government agent.
There goes your,
well,
there goes your record, Derek.
Sorry, everyone. We brought a government agent on the line, and, well, I don't know if we're safe anymore. So, Chris, what is it that you do, and what is it that you've done this week that's pretty unique?
Well, my name's Chris Reitman. I am a selectman. That's kind of a New England thing if people aren't familiar with it. Being a selectman is sort of a cross between being a mayor and a city council. There's usually a board of three selectmans in New Hampshire town that in towns that pretty much operate the government. So the local police chief reports to me, and the administrative functions and the guys that take care of the roads and all that good stuff, they report to us.
That's really personal. Is this a big town?
Alstead's pretty small. We've got about 1,900 people in it. So there are smaller towns, but there are bigger towns too.
Yeah, there were more people in my high school. So that's just really a weird perspective. So, all right. So what happened this week that made news or should be making news?
Well, maybe making news, and it really wasn't intentional. A little bit about Alstead. It's a small New England town, and part of this town we have this thing called Vilas Pool. Vilas Pool is this piece of land that was given to the town by a gentleman named Charles Vilas back in the 1930s, and it's a beautiful little piece of property. There's sort of a pond. It's dammed up, and a bridge to get over to this nice park, and some buildings and boats, and it's just a really, really cool little kind of a mini tourist attraction for Alstead.
Okay.
And every year they celebrate Vilas Pool by having Vilas Pool Days, and that was this last Saturday. So they had people out there, you know, doing face painting for the kids, and the fire department showed up and hooked up their truck and sprayed water out all over the pond. And
yay!
Made rainbows and all sorts of nice things.
Fun. It sounds like a family event, and it's like, you know, got stuff for kids and
very much
nice.
So. Okay. Yeah, it's a nice little event. And during this event, a couple people showed up open carrying. They were carrying sidearms on themselves.
No. Yes. Were they trying to kill people? Were they murdering everybody around them?
There were no fatalities reported. No fatalities reported.
It's all cool over there.
Yeah, yeah. This is completely legal, and we'll get into the legality of it. But they were open carrying, and they believed themselves to be completely legal.
Cool.
However, here's where things get a little sticky.
Have
a previous
government.
Select boards they're a rotating term of 3 years. So, you know, there's always somebody new coming onto the select board, and select boards always change. And some previous select board, we're not exactly sure when, but we know this occurred because a lot of people talk about it, passed a ban on firearms at Vilas Pool. They said that, you know, this is a family type place. It's a park. And we feel it's within our power to ban the use, ban the carry of firearms.
That's exactly the reason why you want firearms to be there if it's a family place. You want to be able to protect your family, right? You want your kids to feel safe somewhere.
You're preaching to the choir.
Plus, it's a contradiction, right?
Yeah. Know, I want it to be safe for my whole family. So why don't we only let criminals carry guns there? Wouldn't that be nice?
Exactly. So here we have the basically the board of directors. And Vilas Pool, while owned by the town, is operated and financed by a trust. Also,
did we lose him?
Did we lose him?
I don't know. Maybe for a second. Maybe we'll come back.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
That's okay. Yeah.
Okay. Hey. There we go.
All right.
Yeah. Sorry. Where did I
go back?
Yeah. Just begin your sentence again, if you will.
Okay. So anyway, Vilas Pool is operated by a trust. The trust was set up by Mr. Vilas also to pay the expenses of Vilas Pool. And there is a board of directors that manages that trust.
Yeah. But even though trusts are non-governmental. So like trusts are sort of private.
Correct.
They predate governments.
They are. They are a private thing. However, the way it was set up.
That kind of makes the pool property, though, private property, right? So
we're going to get into that. We're going to answer that question because there was some confusion about that.
Yeah.
Now, selectmen have we oversee the spending of money for the Vilas Pool Trust. So, you know, if they want new picnic tables, we say here it is. But to your point, Dio, and this is a good one, is who actually owns the land?
Right.
This was a question, and this comes up. So, again, a couple people were open carrying. A couple people that were on the board of directors of the Vilas Pool Trust went over and said, I'm sorry, but there's a restriction on firearms, and we're going to have to ask you to go put those in your car while you're here. And one gentleman that I happen to personally know, they were getting ready to go anyway. So he's like, well, we were getting ready to leave anyway, so no big deal. I'll just head out. And I guess the other gentleman, who I've never met and I don't know, kind of didn't. He had a problem with that. He said, "No, I don't think you can do that." So one of the people with the Vilas Pool Board of Directors called our local cop to sort the whole thing out.
Did you say our local cop, singular?
Yes.
There's one cop in the whole town.
Normally we have.
I'm moving there.
Normally we have all of two, but we are looking for a new police chief. That's
one of
my duties is to hire our new police chief.
What is cop blocking like in a town with only one cop?
Lonely.
Let's go start a crime wave, Derek.
Lonely. That's all I can say.
Oh man.
Shake him up a little bit. We'll give him a little something to write about.
So they
a little excitement.
So they called the cop. They called the town.